On the curvaceous bounty of Sin City do not reflect those of this radio station or its affiliates.
Calypso, Alexia, Sierra, and Sweet Cheeks are personalities put on for your entertainment.
All music, stories, and characters are the sole property of their creators and are protected under international copyright laws.
The stories are real. The language is explicit. The behavior is outrageous.
If you can't take the heat, get the fuck out of the kitchen.
Well, my girl got the sweetest pussy, nestles in her lap. Be the first to admit and want to stroke that kitten, fell right into her trap. Now all that fur and purring gives me cause to pause. She may have a pretty kitty, but watch out for those claws.
Straight out of Las Vegas, Nevada, it is the curvaceous bounty of Sin City, starring Sierra, Calypso, Alexia, and Sweet Cheeks.
Good evening, Las Vegas.
Yeah, you've got to kiss that mic real good.
Yeah, I'm not hearing nothing. And people around the world.
People around the world. What fucking one are you on? You're probably on
Oh, you
two.
Only got one ear
How
working.
How come I don't hear you?
You How's have that? One ear better? Working.
Is that better? How's this one? Is this
I
one
don't
better?
Hear you.
You know, you can always, you can take Platinum's earphones.
Hello, can you hear me? You know, I got lip gloss on, so I don't want no.
Yeah, we can hear you just fine.
Yeah, I hear you just fine.
Mic fuzz on my lips.
We just did a test.
I know, but I didn't hear. No, I can't hear her.
You can't hear me?
No, I cannot hear you at all.
Are you the? Is that me? The only one you can't hear?
Yes.
Is her?
Oh, that's because I'm only broadcasting on one channel, and the channel on her ears that I'm broadcasting on doesn't work.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I don't have to listen to her fucking ass today. Thank you so much.
Fuck off and die.
So how are we going to fix that?
If you need to say... Oh, there you go.
He switched
my channel.
Oh, now I hear you. Wait a minute. Now I hear you better.
Yes, because now I'm in your right ear.
You're in my left ear.
Headphones are on backwards.
But you know what? I did. Wait a minute. I did have both ears a minute ago.
I swear. We check all the headphones and mics before we ever start.
But as is Murphy Laws goes, shit always doesn't work when you need it to.
Right.
Yeah, well.
Oh, I'm so excited about today's show. We have, the last time we had this gentleman in studio.
There was some like homoerotic
Calypso
stuff
wasn't
going
in studio.
In here.
Calypso took the day off. She had something happen with their kids or something like that. So it was just me and Sierra and of course Silent Mike. And it was a total nerd fest.
I heard that I'm going to be lost today because I'm like got no nerdism.
No, because he's got...
I got porn star in me, but no nerdism.
Yeah, he's got coolness too, which is really cool.
She's had a lot of porn star in her.
So we've got the fabulous Pete Housley in studio with us.
Woo-hoo!
And I believe we're going to be joined by Platinum Pussy later on
I just sent her a message. So.
Anything's possible with Platinum.
Right.
God
right.
Only
I know
knows.
That. I think she went to a game in California. I think she went to a basketball game.
She's probably somewhere in Barstow about right now. She'll come flying in here in hours.
Well, that's cool. So we're going to have a good show. But we have a lot to catch up on because I want to know what your Sweet Cheeks reaction was to... the horrible performance by President Obama at the debate.
It was awful.
It was. I was so fucking mad.
Every Obama fan was
fucking
mad.
All I can say, is there has to be a plan. Okay? There has to be a plan because it was so not in his character.
But if they're relying on Joe Biden, they're relying, unfortunately. Don't get me wrong. I love Joe Biden.
Pure entertainment
value.
Oh,
Joe Biden.
Here's how I describe Joe Biden. Joe Biden is a big, dumb dog that sometimes gets it right. And you just love him to death and you can't not love him. But he shits in the house sometimes. And, you know.
But you know what? When he shits in the house, you can't be mad at him because he's so fucking cute.
Exactly.
You know?
You know, you just That's you can't the hate Joe
But you
Biden.
Know what? I can't. Okay. Well, let's talk about the past debate. Then we're going to talk about the debate coming up this week. Okay. I don't know what happened to our very, very, very well-spoken president, but wow.
What happened?
Wow.
What happened was...
He was in the Maha City, and he just got there, and he didn't get used to the elevation.
No. He had bad writers, and he had bad preparation.
That was one of the excuses that the Obama camp was throwing out there.
But, you know what? And I am... You guys know I have this big love affair with Barack Obama, but I do have to say this. I don't care how much Mitt Romney talked. It was fucking a bunch of lies. And I'm not playing with this.
A lot of criticism that Obama got was that he did not call him.
Exactly. Didn't call him out on it. It was so funny because I was sitting at a debate watch party with some of the people I work at the Obama office with. And the field organizer was there. And I looked at her and I'm going, why didn't he say the 47%? And why did he smack him in the face about, you know, the $1 trillion tax hikes? Yeah. And she goes, I don't know. Like, I'm expecting her to know the answers to why didn't he do all
that was
of this?
That sounded,
you know,
so desperate.
I don't know, she says. But very interesting, her and I walked out together, and she was going, of course, back to the office, that every single, there was a big conference call with all of the state Barack offices, and there's something like 70-some offices, but every state was reporting, and because all of the field organizers were at debate watch parties, so they were all supposed to have these big conference calls to give the what the feedback was of the people that were in these debate watch parties. So without a doubt, President Obama is very aware of how everybody felt about, you know, what went on. I don't know what happened. It was so not him.
I don't even know how to explain it. A doppelganger showed up. Well, it was like at the last minute, President Obama came down with really bad stomach flu, so they sent his lookalike, and this guy hasn't been out of the lookalike Heidi hole in a million years, and like he had no idea what the hell he was talking
about. I
have
a feeling that he did not want to be
First of all, he hates Mitt Romney. It's a known fact. And the two of them have not seen each other in 4 years, almost 5 years. And he's not a fan. So, and I think you're right. He was told by his people, don't be on the attack. Don't attack him.
Let other people be the attack dog.
Yes, exactly. And I don't think he expected Romney to come out as hard. I mean, Romney at times was plain rude.
Well, he had to. He had been gaffing. Yeah. For at least a month beforehand.
Right.
Everything he said that came out of his mouth was, oh my God, did he really just say that?
Right.
So he had to come out Romney. Strong. He had to be strong Romney, for this debate.
But they're also saying that debate did not affect the polls in any way, because when you do the fact checking, I mean, Rachel Maddow was great this week because she took it. She'd say something about what Romney said, and then she pulled out another film of him on the campaign stop, and it's like totally different messages. And she did it with like 8 different points.
Right.
So, you know, we still got the point that Romney is molding and saying whatever he needs to say based on whatever environment he's in.
Yeah.
We still have the fact that Romney, and this is what I kept saying, why can't Obama say one word? I just wanted him to keep saying, how? How? You know, every time he said, well, my plan's going to...
Well, that might be construed as too non-political, no, as too non-politically correct. They might think he's making fun of Indian people as a Native American. Because if you keep saying how like that,
here's
at some point,
Romney.
Somebody's getting upset.
My plan does have cover pre-existing conditions. How? My plan will cut the tax deficit by 3 children.
How?
How, Wumpum?
3 children?
$3 trillion.
That could be a Mitt Romney.
You know, I'm going to create 12,000 new jobs in the next 4 years.
How? Fact checkers.
How?
He has created 12 million new jobs, 12 million new fact checkers.
Fact checkers. Yeah, they all have jobs now before.
I saw that post on Facebook.
Yeah.
So
thank God there's 2 more debates, the 16th and the 22nd. The 16th, there will be a debate party at my house.
For the vice presidential one?
No, the vice presidential one is this Wednesday, the 11th. Which I think I can't wait because, you know, well, and here we have Paul Ryan. They're asking him.
Who scares the fucking bejesus out of me, by
me
the way.
Me too.
His eyeballs.
So you know. Well, you know what? They ask him, like, okay, so, like, you know, in your tax, because he's supposed to be the big tax plan guy, you know, and he goes, well, it's just too complicated for me to explain the math to you.
Then how do you understand it, and why can't you explain it?
They can't, you know, go tell me that you're going to make, you know, a village on the moon. but you can't tell me how you're going to do it. They cannot tell us how they're going to do anything.
Right. Well, that's been the complaint about the Romney campaign.
And he's still not answering.
How they're going to. Exactly. But it's like they don't want to tell you how, and that's a defense. They don't want to tell you how because we don't want you to steal our ideas.
We can't tell you what's in this bill until you approve this bill.
I know. Who was that? What senator said that?
Fuck,
wasn't
I don't
that
know.
Pelosi or something
some
like that?
Crazy lady.
Well, and here's the thing. Well, there's, you know, he was talking about, well, I'm going to make cuts. And they're like, okay, so what are some of the cuts that you would make so that you can give the rich people another 20% tax break? Okay, Big Bird.
Yeah.
He's going to cut PBS.
Isn't Big Bird fired already? Isn't Sesame Street done anyway?
No, it's not. Every day. No. Trust me, it's out of my house every day.
Here's the thing.
But the problem, though, doesn't PBS, like, they get donations and stuff
well,
for that?
Well,
right?
It's so little of what the government gives.
Part of it is government funding.
Here it is. It is 0.012% of the national federal budget. For PBS every year. It's not even 0.2% of the budget.
So
now they would actually save more money by cutting every senator and every If we took every politician that we have who makes six figures or more and we cut their salary in half, we would save more on the national federal budget than by cutting PBS.
Well, if they did that, then those politicians would insist on Washington paying for their airfare to go to wherever they need to go and paying for their
hotel
rooms.
They already do that.
Not all of it.
They subsidize their housing in Washington.
So then it would go up again.
Well, here's the thing.
So convoluted up there.
But if I can live on less than $20,000 a year, I'm sure they can live on, instead of $600,000 a year, $300,000
exactly,
a year.
Exactly.
I'm not saying taking them down to the average American income.
Wait. There are politicians that make $600,000 because I don't think our president only makes $500,000.
No, $400,000 the president makes, yeah. And he has to pay for all their own food in the White House.
Right.
Like, that's not the only time that the groceries are covered in the White House is if there's a state party.
He also pays
for his mother-in-law to live there because she stays and helps out with the girls. So yeah, the president doesn't make all that much. Like there's congressmen. And senators making more than our president.
Yeah, I thought it was like $500,000
because
a year.
Because the president's salary is written into the Constitution. Senators and congressmen is not. And every year they give themselves a raise.
That's true.
Every single
Are you political,
year.
Pete?
Yep.
Yeah?
Yeah, I watched the debates. I kind of blame Jim Lehrer for a lot of the debate being a disaster.
Well, you know what?
Was he even there?
He had no control. No control at all.
Absolutely. Mitt Romney interrupted him more times than
I can
count.
That's what I'm saying.
They
should
have had, you know what? Here is for the Obama campaign people. Go have Jon Stewart write your shit from now on. Because then everyone will love you. Just do it.
That would be so funny.
Just do it.
Well, and you know, Obama, they were saying that... Obama is a very good speaker. He's not a great debater.
No.
But they did, you know, they have all said that Romney was a better debater. And
we already know Romney is a great master debater.
He's a great master fucking liar.
I think
Hello?
We're going with master debater there.
But you know, Romney's had several, I think it's something, the number was something like 22 debates since Obama has had even, you know, in the 4 years, because he ran, you know, all of the primaries and stuff.
Those are just excuses.
No, you're right. I think it stunk.
I think Obama didn't want to be aggressive.
You're right.
And he needs to be, unfortunately.
Well, I think we're going to see a different man
speaking
come
of,
in the 16th.
Speaking of Jon Stewart, on one of the shows that I watched, I think it was Thursday's show that I watched, he said, if you could have been at least part of what your emails are that I get 10 times a day.
True. The fundraiser emails are a little out of control.
I get them, yeah.
You know what? I emailed the White House once, and I've had one response. I don't get emails from them.
Really?
Oh, my God.
I'm pretty sure I've gotten four since we started
the
show.
Right.
From
me
Obama.
Too. Me too.
Right.
And Michelle.
Yeah.
Michelle sends
a lot,
and all those other people.
Oh, Billy Clinton. I've got them from Billy Clinton.
Well, Bill Clinton's in Vegas this week on Tuesday.
Is he?
Yeah,
but
he speaks Springs Preserve.
The fervor that they want us to be riled up as, like the ads I've seen on Facebook are, how can you have Obama's back if you're not registered to vote? So that was the big thing, right?
Because yesterday was the last day to register to vote.
And then somebody today posted, I got his back, and it's got the back of Obama's head with the Obama logo underneath, 2012. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, if they want us to be in that kind of fervor, then we need to expect that from the people who are... The person
we
who's going
to
be our president,
it from
right?
Obama.
Well, yeah. I had to go to the, what night? Wait, the Oh, I went to the Obama office Thursday night. The debate was Wednesday. And I walked in there and I go, all right, who's got the bat phone? Because I need to fire up our president. Give me the phone to call Barack, you know? Yeah, it was not the Barack we know and love. It pissed me off. But I know there's a plan. And the next debate, the next presidential debate, is a town hall format. So there's no mediator.
No moderator?
No, yeah, there's no moderator. It's just you asking questions to the candidate.
There has to be some kind of moderator.
I only have one question for Mitt Romney. Can I borrow $60,000? I just need $60,000. And for you, that's like a drop in the fucking bucket. That's all I need.
Wendy of Neverland has a bunch of things that she wants to say. Fact checkers were kept real busy during the debate, but Obama lost a great opportunity when he didn't push back.
Yes, mm-hmm. Absolutely.
She also says, whoa! Mama has Death Valley style cleavage tonight. We all look at her cleavage.
Don't cover it up.
She says, conservatives don't like PBS because it doesn't lie for them. Quote, we shouldn't pay a network that doesn't fall in line with our crap, unquote. And then she said, ask Sierra if Romney responded to her on health care or not on health care earlier this week.
No, I have not received a single response.
Can we talk about your health care issue? Because I think your issue is the number one reason why I am here for the Democratic Party
right
now.
Can we get a close-up of that?
Yeah. Please. I know some of it's personal issues, but it all has to do with the state of health care. And I just want to say this about while we're showing Sierra's eyeball.
Sierra's bloodshot. She's ready for Halloween with that bloodshot eyeball.
She is. Wednesday night, you guys, watch the debate, because we've got Mr. Analytical Paul Ryan.
And Big Dumb Biden.
And Daddy Biden. I think that Biden is such a like an old home Joe. Like I just want to say,
come on over, Joe.
You know, let's sit on the porch.
I want to give him
a
milk bone and scratch him behind.
Oh, you're
his ears.
So bad. But so Wednesday should
he's
be
just
a
the
fun
kind of dog I like to have. Big
Wednesday
dogs
should be fun.
Sometimes don't poop in the house.
Wednesday should be a fun debate. So anyway, go on, because your situation is why I want Obama to stay in office.
So. My situation is ongoing, and it's just one thing compounding upon another. A few months ago, you all know I didn't have my period for 2 months, and then I had my period for 2 months. And then I got diagnosed with premature ovarian failure. Well, I'm on hormone replacement therapy for that. And the hormone replacement therapy has caused my gallbladder to form gallstones. And so Wednesday night, I ended up in the emergency room in so much pain. I had vomited twice before I got there. I vomited once in the waiting room and then once again after we got home. But that was from all of the pain meds that I was on at this point. It took a shot of morphine, 2 shots of Dilaudid, and something else that I don't remember right in my ass, but I know it hurt when they gave it to me, before I had any pain relief. Before I had total pain relief. I went from like a 10.2 on the pain scale to an 8 with the morphine, to a 7.5 with the first shot of Dilaudid. I went back up to an 8 with whatever it was they put in my ass because the pain from the shot was so bad. I finally went down to like a 1 or a 2 with the last shot of Dilaudid. Once they had relieved me of my pain, they sent me home. They did an ultrasound and they found that my gallbladder is full of gallstones, but they're not blocking anything. All of my blood work comes back normal and fine, so I don't need immediate emergency surgery on removing my gallbladder. So they sent me home with a prescription for Percocet and a referral to the surgery center, the local university. We have UMC, our University Medical Center, their surgery center. The next day, I called the surgery center, and the surgery center says, oh, well, they skipped a step because I don't have insurance. Now, mind you, I have paid for everything that I have had in full and out of my pocket. The gynecologist, the regular physician, all of the medications that I've been on, every test that I've had done, everything has come out of my pocket because I don't have insurance. Not because I don't want insurance, but because my company does not offer insurance to part-time employees, and I'm a part-time employee. And I'm not part-time by choice. I'm part-time because I got laid off, and then I found a job because I needed to have a job, and it sucked and didn't pay much, so I looked for another job. I found another job that didn't suck as much and paid more. Unfortunately, it just wasn't full-time and didn't come with benefits. I wasn't expecting to need a surgery anytime in being less than 40, I didn't think that I was going to need any major medical assistance.
Way less than 40.
Yeah, I'm 32. All of this has happened, and I'm not even 33 years old yet. So I call. So the surgery center told me straight out, and this is the people who cannot refuse you treatment. They can refuse you surgery. They cannot refuse you treatment. Treatment is Percocet for the rest of my life. Painkillers. Trips to the emergency room. They will not deny me that.
Well, of course, that's the Romney healthcare plan, right?
Well, they
trips
can't.
Trips to the emergency room?
Well, they will cover my insurance. They will cover it. I have to either have insurance or pay for the surgery, pay for the surgery center up front. That does not include the anesthesiologist, the cost of the actual surgeon himself, any nurses that are needed,
medications,
any
you
medication
need.
That is needed during the surgery,
any aftercare.
Yeah, I just have to pay for the actual surgery center and the cost of it up front in full. I can't make a deposit of 50% and then make payments. I can't do any of that. I have to have it up front. And I called every surgery center in this city, and they all said the exact same thing. Either you have insurance or you pay for it up front, but you're not getting it any other way. I don't qualify for Medicaid because I cannot claim my child. Because in order to claim my child, I have to be getting child support from my son's father, who, if he pays me child support, has to go on welfare to support himself because he doesn't make that much more money than I do. So in order for me to get a few thousand dollars worth of Medicaid, I have to cost the state a few tens of thousands of dollars to go through the entire custody case, because we can't pay for the lawyers or all of that out of our pocket, so the state's going to have to pay for it. Because in order for me to get Medicaid, the state has said that they will pursue my son's father.
Well, and what I think is so fucking nuts about this is that, okay, your son is covered under his father's health care, mm-hmm. okay? He's done. You're not asking for any kind of benefits
for my son.
Which, nope. If you were,
I'm not
then
asking
I understand.
For welfare.
Right.
I'm
you're
not,
not
asking
for
food
TANF, stamps,
I'm
nothing.
Not for nothing.
So if you were, I totally understand them going back to his father and saying, you owe us. Now,
right, because,
your relationship.
Because actually, according to the state of Nevada, if I use the child support that I receive to pay for my own medical bills, I'm in violation of a state law.
Exactly.
So I don't see how my son's child support should affect my need for Medicaid.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with you because you're not asking right. for anything for your son.
Now,
so that
have,
is fucked
I do,
up.
I do have one last route that I can go on, and that is there is a social services thing that is put on by medical centers and whatnot. I don't know how exactly it's funded or worked. But there is a very real possibility that because I do make good money, I don't make great money, I make enough money to survive. I don't make enough money to go on vacation, but I make enough money to pay for my food and gas every week. I can't live on my own. I don't make enough money to live on my own, so I have to live with my mom. I tried budgeting it, and if I found a place for $500 a month and I only paid $200 a month in utilities, I would still be $400 over what I make every month.
I understand.
And so I can't live on my own, so I live with my mom. So the social services thing, but I have that option, but there's a very real possibility that I make too much money for social services mm-hmm. because I make too much money for Medicaid. And
well, the social service one is a state program. Medicaid would be a federal program.
No, Medicaid is a state program.
Is it a state program? Mm-hmm. But, you know, I mean, listen to what she's saying, people. I mean, this is a person.
And I can't afford private health insurance because the private health insurance for a female 30 with pre-existing conditions, because they'll charge you more for having pre-existing conditions, and I do have a few pre-existing conditions, nothing life-threatening, mind you, but they're pre-existing, is more than half of what I make
every
month.
Well, you want to hear this? After my COBRA ran out when I got laid off, I called some private providers, and you know, there again, they have to take your pre-existing because of part of Obamacare.
But they can charge you whatever they want.
Hello, $700 a month. They want to charge me because of my age and because I have been on arthritis medication for 10 years that they, like $700, that's more than my mortgage.
The only way that I could get help, because initially when we came, I came back to Vegas, I had been in California for a couple of years, and DJ was saying, we have to get you something because we need to, regardless of what size you are, I want you to be healthy. So we started shopping, and we had people coming and, you know, showing us different things. And because I had pre-existing conditions, thyroid and blood pressure issues. At one point, I think the lowest one was about $800 a month. And then they finally said, no, we can't touch you because you have pre-existing condition. The only way that I ended up getting some insurance for me, because nobody would touch me, is I got pregnant with Donald, and then I qualified for Medicaid.
Yep. Right. Yeah, if you're pregnant, they'll take care of you.
Well, the government has a new program. I'm not sure if you're aware, but I happen to have just done some research on this. And you can find out about it. It's at pcip.gov. And it's actually an insurance program for pre-existing conditions. And it's a program that's set up like that.
Awesome.
And it's got a flat rate based on your age. And it's, you know, it's got a $4,000 deductible and that kind of stuff.
Well,
but there's at least insurance. There's some programs, and it's part of the Obamacare stuff.
Okay.
Only 27 states. PCIP.gov. But only 27 states are currently supporting it.
Now, you know what? Now, the thing is that Obamacare is not perfect. And I don't think anybody, including President Obama, is going to tell you it's a perfect plan.
And no one who has tried any sort of, and I'm going to loosely quote this because there isn't an actual socialized healthcare system out there. There are a lot of government-run healthcare systems, but there's still a lot of out-of-pocket expenditure that comes to a lot of people. No one has gotten healthcare right, period. And no one is going to get healthcare right, period. Until we completely break down the system and go back to the way we were a million years ago, and that's everyone dying at 32 instead of having, you know.
Right. Well, and here's what I don't understand. I don't understand why.
I'm not asking for a handout. I'm not asking for it for free. You know what? I don't even care if you give it to me at a reduced rate. All I'm asking for is the opportunity to have the surgery done in a timely manner. Because if I have to save the money myself in order to pay even a fraction of the cost.
That's the big deal, is that you need to pay up front.
They want
all of it up front.
And that's only for the surgery center. That doesn't cover all of the other costs that are going to happen afterwards.
Well, and the doctor's going to ask you for up front. The anesthesiologist is going to ask you for the money
especially
up front.
If you're paying cash. And now, did they tell you, did I hear you, or right, did you say that they were telling you that the surgery was an elective surgery?
Yes.
It is an elective
surgery.
What did you just read online?
I read an article online that said, once your gallstones cause gallbladder problems, you must have your gallbladder removed. And that is everything that I have ever read anywhere, everywhere. Every doctor online, and I know that it's online and you can't trust everything you read online, but when 100% of all the MDs on WebMD and all the other websites say, once your gallbladder causes you pain that puts you in the emergency room, you must have your gallbladder removed.
But here's the thing, and Mama can tell us for a fact, because Mama was having a heart attack, and they take you into the, if you don't have insurance.
Mama, you?
Yeah.
After I had Donald, I had postpartum cardiomyopathy, which is
And all they have to do if you don't have insurance is stabilize you.
And send you home. That's all they did for me.
Stabilize you.
They reduced my pain. They did an ultrasound to diagnose me. And they sent me home with a prescription and a referral to the surgery center. And the surgery center told me straight out, it's an elective surgery, so we will not perform it unless
here's
you have
Here's
insurance.
What I don't understand.
As the devil's advocate, not that I like the devil, but isn't this like a form of survival of the fittest? If you can't afford the insurance, then maybe you got to go, and only the people who can stay and afford their own insurance should be able to stay?
That's a hell. No, that's not
that's
survival of the fittest.
That's kind of fucked up.
That's survival of the richest. Because I'm telling you right now, if you put me and Mitt Romney out in a field with a hunting knife, I'm going to live and I'm going to eat his ass. That's what's going to fucking happen.
Now, one of the things that got my goat was I'm pretty liberal. You know, I've got some conservative values, but I'm pretty liberal, and I am always willing to help people when I've got the extra money to do it. We were talking about this earlier before the show started. Now, Sierra posted her social agenda online about her medical problems, and she got a response from somebody, and we won't mention her name or anything.
I wish I could, though.
And
you know, we're going to call her Skunt number two. That's what we're going to call you. You are now Skunt number two.
And I just could not believe the cold-heartedness of some of these people. These people who spout the rhetoric that, you know, if you can't afford the insurance, then you don't get the insurance.
Well,
and
see,
why should you be handing for a handout?
Yeah,
and
ask,
why should I have to pay for you to have
medical
care?
I'm under full belief that those people do not know what it's like not to have insurance. Because up until 4 years ago when I got laid off, I have, in my adult life, have never been without health care because I've always had a job. Now since I've had to go through all of these changes with my own health care and stuff, I get it, okay? These people totally don't get it, nor do they want to get it. In their mind, Sierra is just lazy,
and
she just chooses not to work, and she sits home by the pool all day, and any money she gets, she's out drinking beer and buying drugs,
spending it on whatever.
Yeah,
and like, honey, and this shirt is 5 years old.
Yeah, so
these pants are 2 years old. These flip flops are brand new, but that's because they were on sale for $1.99.
Hey, I thought those were the hand-me-down flip flops I gave you.
No, they're not. But I do have a pair of hand-me-down flip flops.
That's right. So you know what? And here's what
this
I don't understand.
This bra is 10 years old, and it's the only one I can wear because underwires hurt because my gallbladder's enlarged.
Here's the thing. Let's think about this, you guys. Okay, let's think about this. Right now, when somebody goes into an emergency room with no insurance and they're taken care of, ultimately the government is subsidizing that stuff to help pay so the hospitals can stay open. All right. So the initial coverage if Obamacare stays in effect in 2014, when there's the mandate for insurance, what's going to happen is, everybody's going to have insurance. But if you think about this, people, all of the medical costs then will be off of the government's back and onto the insurance company's back where it should be.
I think our show is too serious.
Right at this minute it is. But we're going to take a break now. You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City at Vegas All Net Radio. Vote Obama!
Go to the donate button and send me money. I need it.
This is Sierra from the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City, urging you to adopt, not shop. There are hundreds of thousands of animals out there looking for homes, and you could be their next forever home. Visit your local animal shelter today to find your next family member.
Get connected to your audience with Endeavor Media Group. Find them online at emgnv.com.
Embrace your endeavors and take it to the limit with Endeavor Media Group. Visit them online at emgnv.com.
If you're looking to further your acting, modeling, or athletic career, contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
Endeavor Media Group is a sports and entertainment PR firm, connecting its clients with audiences everywhere through movies, television, radio, publications, websites, mobile applications, and special events. Visit emgnv.com.
EMG represents clients of all sizes and in a variety of industries. The firm works with companies, organizations, famous individuals, and political groups to advance their interests, manage communication-related matters, promote products and services, handle issues, and mitigate specific problems. Visit Endeavor Media Group online at emgnv.com.
Join us at the annual trade show where all your favorite adult BBW performers will be. BBW Fan Fest 2013, coming July 26th, 27th, and 28th here in fabulous Las Vegas. Find BBW Fan Fest on Facebook for more info.
Sweet Cheeks, the Fat Chinista with the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City. Join myself, Alexia, Sierra, and Calypso on Sunday nights from 7 to 10 at VegasAllNetRadio.com. I'll show you how stylish it is to feel good about yourself, love yourself at any size, show your arms, dress cute, and walk proud. Check us and our cleavages out at SinCityBounty.com.
Stay up to date with your favorite BBW girls on Twitter. Go to BBWGirlTweet.com to find all your favorite adult BBW entertainers.
Welcome back to the award-winning Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City at VegasAllNetRadio.com. And
didn't we beat you for that award, too?
What?
For FanFest, the award.
Special recognition
I wasn't
award.
At FanFest.
I know you weren't there, but I think you were.
I was in Chicago.
You were in our category.
All right, I just want to say one more political thing. Wednesday night, it's going to be a great debate, the vice presidential debate.
Where is this party at?
Well, Wednesday, I haven't got the notice, but the 16th is at my house. There's a debate watch party.
Is it open to anybody?
I will have anybody that wants to come.
Is there going
to
be snacks?
Right. There will be snacks, okay. And you can bring snacks, too.
You can message us at info@sincitybounty.com if you're interested in coming to the debate party. I'm going to be there. Are you going to be there?
It starts at 6 o'clock, the debates start.
You have to kiss them.
Little potluck thing. I'm gonna make some little
meatballs
luscious things.
Good.
Meatballs are good.
Yes, those are like awesome.
You already planned it out. Meatballs and also good. I want to encourage everybody,
because I'm pretty sure I won't have my surgery by the 16th. I'm gonna have to bring my own food. Because I have to be on a special diet.
Right.
Yeah. I just want to tell everybody, too, October 20th, which is 2 weeks from yesterday, early voting starts in Nevada.
Right.
We will win this election, and by we, I mean the Barack Obama team. Because I don't fucking care.
Because if Barack Obama won't fight for himself, the fuck the rest of us will.
I know. He will. He's going to come out swinging next time, I promise. We've talked about it. You know, me and him,
You know what'll be great is if you promising us he's going to come out swinging next time, and he comes out and he goes, you guys know where I stand, and then walks off the stage. That would be awesome.
That would be political suicide. It would be. But no, seriously, everybody try to get out and vote earlier. We will win this in the early vote.
I just have one more political
vote.
Thing I want to say.
And I'm done. That's what I wanted to say. Vote early.
Now,
October 20th.
Do we all get to say one more political thing?
You can. Go ahead.
I want to ask Pete a question. Now, you go to a lot of events in town. I see your pictures all over the place. True. You're hanging out with porn stars. You're hanging out with strippers. You're hanging out with all these great people.
Wait a minute. He's the male version of her.
Right.
Sweet cheeks.
Are you political when you're out at these events as well?
No, absolutely not.
No, you don't. You don't say you're voting for Obama, right?
No.
I can't fucking keep my mouth shut about it, Pete. Okay.
Well, I got a question for you. Are porn stars more Democratic or more Republican?
That's an easy answer.
Huh? Did that answer your question?
So they're undecided.
They seem to have problems.
they're independent.
We've been working with the Free Speech Coalition over the last couple of weeks on the Measure B issue in California too, and trying to motivate the porn stars in the talent in the business has been a true challenge. With more than 5 or 6 million followers on Twitter, we thought, wow, we could really reach some people about the Measure B problem. And
What is the Measure B problem?
The Measure B problem in LA County is that they're trying to mandate condoms on
set.
That's
right. Okay.
So if we can't even motivate them to deal with the condom on set issue, trying to motivate them on larger issues like a presidential election is
What? In reality, most of these girls are self-employed, so they're not under an employer that provides them health insurance.
Absolutely.
So they've got the same issues that we're sitting here talking about.
Well, they have other issues. Just being self-employed is issue.
Exactly.
You know, having to pay your own taxes is an issue.
Yeah, but you know, as we get older, we start thinking about those things. These girls are 18, 21, 22 years old. They just don't think about those things. You know, they don't think they're going to be in Sierra's. Situation
there
10 years
are
from
older
now.
Porn stars.
True, I'm not arguing that. Those
Everyone
are the ones that typically have their stuff together. You know?
There are gilfs.
Everyone
world.
Loves a gilf.
True. But the answer is having a political science degree, part of it is learning when to be political and when not to be. So.
When to be political.
You can
be
political here all you want, because it is in my blood. I was saying to somebody the other day, I was like, what the fuck am I going to do after the election? Maybe I'll get fucked more often after the election because
more time for deals.
I'm at the Obama office all the time. But like, you guys know that I spend my day with children. So like, my little outs to the Obama office is like my adult time, you know?
You won't have PBS to help you anymore. So
true.
I have to get rid of all my children during the day because I can't let them.
Hey, do you know that I was just watching something? DJ was watching. I don't. He every channel. I swear, when he's home, we watch his news. But
yay, DJ, and he's watching MSNBC too. I know.
No, they were talking about the Sesame Street and all of the places that sell Sesame Street things.
Mm-hmm.
All of the Sesame Street things are like flying off the fucking shelves.
Yep. You're kidding, because they really think
I swear. I just saw it before I walked out of the house. They said they were, like, selling everything.
Yeah.
get to the dollar store and buy your Sesame Street shit now because it'll be worth $2 next year.
I'm like, Is that because they really think that Mitt Romney's going to cut Sesame Street?
I don't
know. He did a really good job at the debate.
I don't know, but I got a whole fucking room of Sesame Street shit, so I'm in there.
You're raking it.
Maybe your college is going to be paid for by
Elmo.
I'm going to tell you,
if that man gets put into office, I have to leave the country.
Canada?
You know, a lot of people said that when it was Clinton against Bush. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people said that when it was Gore against Bush. And a lot of people said that. I think the only person that left the country was Johnny Depp. He moved to France.
I'm going to tell you, Mitt Romney is scary. And no, Paul Ryan is scary.
Mitt Romney does not scare me nearly as much as Paul Ryan does.
Well, the two together.
I mean, because Mitt Romney can't keep his story straight anyway.
That's true.
He's going to spend his entire time in the office deciding what he's going
to
lie about next.
So we're going to have two shows. Not to beat a dead horse, but we're still talking politics.
I know.
We are.
Pete Housley, penis.
Myself.
True. Wait. I can say butt plug.
Oh, yeah. Show us a butt plug.
Frosted glass butt plug.
It's a glow in the dark.
And it glows in the dark. Can we turn the light out?
Well, we could talk about... it glows in the dark.
Yeah, it glows in the dark. Butt plug.
That hurts. I'm sorry. I don't want that in my spokes.
Well, it's a little one.
You have to do your Carol Merrill.
I don't want it in my spokes.
That's a little one.
I don't want it in my spokes.
Alexia, you have to do your Carol Merrill when you're showing stuff.
Yeah.
That's Vanna.
Vanna White.
No, that's from
Carol Merrill. You're showing your age.
Wow,
bitch.
No doubt. I don't even
We're
know
giving it away.
My mommy used to watch it.
How do you want
to
give this away?
Pete, you're giving that butt plug away?
Yeah.
Okay, how are we doing it?
No.
How are we doing it?
Well, that's pretty simple.
Do you want to have like a question?
Be quiet, I'm sitting
ask,
next to him.
Ask,
true.
Ask a question or...
whatever you care. This is from our good friends at Crystal Delight Toys. We're doing a bunch of stuff with them. In fact, we have a porn star.
Why does it have a bunny rabbit?
They have the. They just won an award this year, the AVN Award for this one. This one glows in the dark, and then we have a new porn star tweet one coming out, and then we just helped them do Spartacus, the big Marcus London movie that just came out. There's a new Spartacus toy that I just got, which is a torch. And it's a double-headed dildo torch.
Look at Mama's
very
face.
Very cool. You can use it both ways, Mama.
Does it start on fire?
It's a little hot.
It actually looks like it's on fire on top, and it's a handle at the bottom. And then at the forthcoming Exotica in New Jersey, we will have a full-size sword dildo, which we will be giving away there. So it's going to be a... It's cool because all this stuff is glass. Yeah, true.
So when we figure out how we're going to give this away,
Sierra's going to run outside and call in.
You get the glow in the dark butt plug, and you get this beautiful bag that goes with it.
I like to call it a scrotum.
You like to call the bag the scrotum?
The scrotum will come along with your butt plug.
Well, how are we giving this away, Pete?
I don't know.
What are we doing?
This is your show. I just bring the toy.
I think we should have a guesstimate of how many hits are on my ex-hamster video right now.
Ooh, that's a good one.
DJ, don't post it. Don't post it yet.
No peeking it. Well, we can't do that because I could go and like
look at it.
Because you know all of our listeners have it bookmarked in there.
Okay, why is he looking at me like that now?
I don't even know what... You've got a hamster?
She's got two ex-hamster videos up.
Oh, very nice.
She's our very own amateur porn star.
Diamond Dave says, is that Mama squirming with excitement over that butt plug?
she scoped me when I walked in with that thing. I had it in my back pocket. She's like,
when do we get to see that video, Mama?
Oh, I've got the link. You want me to forward it to you?
No, the one with her using that butt plug glowing in the dark.
Don't forget to forward that link to me.
Hey, get connected with your audience with Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on vegasallnetradio.com, and we're streaming live at our website, sincitybounty.com. We have the fabulous Pete Housley here in studio with us, who blew up our Twitter when...
about an hour before the show.
Porn executive tweet, girl tweet.
We went to work.
Porn legend tweet, stripper karaoke, glam tweet, cam girl tweet, tranny star tweet, porn star tweet, urban star tweet, naughty tweet, naughty wish list, alt girl tweet, strip clubs tweet, industry tweet, gay star tweet, kink tweet, tattle XXX, BBW girl tweet, all twittered at once that they were going to be on the
show. You know what? As you're going through that list, I'm going, oh, I could fit in that category, and I could fit in that category.
Oh, he apparently hasn't updated the numbers that he sent you because there's a couple of hundred more than that already.
Oh, no, he just sent that to me.
Well, there's at least 124 more than that already.
That's because they know you're,
that's just
you're
like
online
in the
right
last
now.
Hour.
Yeah, that's because you're online. Yeah, yeah, see, you're, here's on, the, you're on.
See, here's
do you
the
have
number.
Any naughty videos up at X-Hamster?
I tried. Yeah, no.
No.
I said to Mama earlier, she said, why do you keep scooting away from me? I said, well, I'm less scooting away from you and more scooting away from that camera that's pointed at me.
Mama so, don't bite unless you ask her to.
That's what I'm scared of.
So you do a lot of things with porn stars in the sex industry, but you are pretty clean.
I'm a pretty nice guy.
Pretty nice guy.
Do you have a significant other?
I do.
Ooh.
And what does she think of all of this?
She's in the business.
Do well, we know her?
She's not. She's not a porn star.
Oh,
she's in the marketing.
She a fluffer?
No, fluffer. Yeah. No, I'm not dating platinum.
Speaking of platinum, she will be here, calling in at 8:30.
She's not here, so she's on the chopping block. So
that's what.
So, but she will be calling in at 8:30, so you can give her hell, Pete.
Please.
When Wendy goes, I hope he's giving it away pristine and not used. The only handling it's had is myself and Pete so far.
Yeah, just get that stuff that cleans your toys.
Always. You should always clean your stuff.
You know, we could put it between all of our breasts and then it'll have some boob juice on it once you get it.
I'm sure some guy will want that.
Well, we've got a couple of lesbians who listen. I'm sure they'd like it too.
Can I tell you about this Taboo I watched this week?
Okay.
Did you talk? You watch?
I watched it.
I've always heard about foot fetishes, okay?
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, okay, so foot weird. Fetishes, they like feet.
Before you get into all that, for those of you who don't know what a foot fetish is, it's people who really, really like feet.
They get off on feet.
They get off on, they like playing with the toes, they like.
Well, different fetishes have different fetishes.
True. Well, I'm telling you, this guy on this show was the king master of foot fetishes. He would hire foot models. Now, I'm seeing all, and he's got like 5 million pictures of feet. Feet in shoes, feet barefoot, feet all over.
Feet covered in food. I mean,
yes,
he just likes some feet.
Likes some feet. And he hires these foot models, and they're all men. So, yes, he is gay.
And some good-looking men on that
yes,
site, too.
Yes, there are, okay? And he'll tell them before they come over to keep their shoes on for a few days, kind of like the panty guys do, okay? And he puts each one, and this guy is so organized, each an individual Ziploc with their name on it. He's got 3,500 CDs.
He's got a way to reactivate the smell in a sock.
Whoa! Yes, yes,
so
he does.
So he's got socks that are like 5 years old. Uh-huh. Well, he does. He lightly coats it, and then he puts it, he sprays it with water, and then he puts it in the microwave for 20 seconds.
No, 12.
12 seconds.
12 seconds.
And then he'll pull it out, and he's right there. He pulled it out of there, and he was like.
Are you as creeped out by this as I am?
Very.
Oh,
okay, good.
Yeah, he has guys.
I'm just like, okay, no. I was okay with the foot shit.
Foot fetish I'm okay with, but.
Reactivating microwave.
No, like keeping people's shoes. He probably has heads in freezers,
and he
too.
He actually talks about.
No, but he's got shoes
how,
in boxes.
Wait, but it's.
That's creepy.
Yeah. Hockey cleats or hockey skates and football cleats, anything men, boots.
So that's his fetish them. Is the smell of people's feet.
Well, not
no,
only that.
Just not
only
just
that.
The smell.
Like he'll have his models come. Like he has this one guy who's been his foot model for 10 years and he sits in the chair and this guy becomes his footstool. Then the guy, the foot fetish guy will, you know, smell and lick and wash his feet and... he's just engulfed.
So there's
with
a little
the
bit of
S&M thing.
In that mix.
There is they did mention that there is a little bit of domination
because it's
submission.
Not yes. always the yes. case with foot fetish.
Yes. So the model
dominates.
Just sits there and like is the
yes. just sits there fully clothed.
He's not sexual.
There's no not in this these 5 million pictures he's got. Oh, not one is pornographic.
Really?
No.
Well,
it's
not
all
for
of,
us.
Yeah, right. I mean, for him, obviously, he gets a hard on somewhere right. in
porn,
the whole thing.
Porn
but
is
his
a very
pictures.
Wide and varied industry.
But in all of his pictures, everybody's fully clothed. And it's all about the
now,
feet.
Now, why did this one particular site catch your eye?
Well, I watched that show's crazy anyway.
Oh, Taboo.
Taboo. But he has his own site. It's called footfraternity.com.
Footfraternity.
Anyway, I told Mama to try to get this guy on the show. But, you know, it's like other fetishes. Like, you hear about it, you know about it. You know, I'm thinking of foot fetish. You know, a guy likes
you know,
to play
really,
with his penis with
I'm
his
gonna,
feet.
We're really familiar with, like, feeders and feeties. Like, that's a fetish that we're very familiar
this,
with.
This is this guy's just over the top.
I'm gonna have DJ contact him and tell him he's got some boots that are that he might be interested in.
Yeah, he likes.
I just figured out where you can get $60,000.
Right.
Well, you and I will go down to Goodwill. We'll buy some old shoes. We'll send them to the guys.
Well, and the taboo show.
If I go down to Goodwill and buy good-looking new shoes, I could go get the old shoes from the hobos. He'd like those better because I'm sure they're stinkier. And their socks.
Well, this show was not about like fetishes. It was about collectors, people that collect things. Because they had Dr. Lonnie Hennigan, you know the guy?
Hennigan, yeah.
With his collection
his three houses of crap.
He was on the same show.
I love Lonnie, by the way. He's a great guy.
He's a really nice guy. I could not be his wife.
They show now.
She lives in her own house.
Yeah,
right.
The third house down. She does have her own house.
Nice.
It's great, though, because they showed, like, he bought a snake skin at an auction, and he brought it home. She's like, that's not coming in here. You've got to take it.
But did you notice when they were showing that? I want to know what he pays for the cleaning people, because not one bit of dust was on any place in that house. So he must pay thousands of dollars a week for the little...
I'll go fucking dust his shit if he'll pay for my surgery.
He might be able to do your surgery. He's a surgeon.
He's a heart surgeon.
No, he's not. He's a neurosurgeon.
Oh, yeah. Well, whatever. But something I don't need.
He probably cleans for TV. We were watching some TV show on HGTV the other day, and the camera crew shows up, and there's like baby stuff everywhere. And kids.
Oh,
I'm like,
okay,
come on. You didn't know the camera crew was on its way, you know?
Because I kept saying, where's like, the dust on all this shit?
You
got
to clean the house, you know?
Okay.
If you're coming to my house with a camera
crew,
I'm
cleaning. The wife says, I think he's a hoarder. Like, you think?
Now, it's the taboo that you're talking about. Is that the same one where the people like... There was people on there that had like 10,000 Cabbage Patch dolls, and there was a bitch.
No, that's hoarders.
No,
that wasn't this episode, but I think it was another episode.
And there's a girl like that licks nail polish. And
no, you're no, thinking of lady. My Strange Addiction.
Okay. Yeah, you're thinking of My Strange Addiction.
You don't watch that one?
Oh yeah.
Oh.
That was the one we talked about last week when the lady was licking the
Yeah, see, I don't care for the hoarder ashes. Shows and the ash eating and the shit like that. Like, I'm not a big fan of that, but I do watch Curiosity and Taboo. Taboo mostly because, like, they had
National
one.
National Geographic, so it's supposed to be, like, a learning thing.
Well, whatever.
it's about as educational as I get, okay?
Well,
other than Sesame Street.
I got hooked on Curiosity because the first episode they ever did had Maggie Gyllenhaal doing narrating a bit about sex, and I think she's my lesbian lover. I would bone her today, now.
Wait, and now, have her there's talk a show about called sex. Curiosity? Mm-hmm. What channel is that on?
Nat Geo.
Well, shit.
Oh, no,
I
it's on the Science
one.
Channel. Okay, Curiosity is on the Science Channel. It may only be a DirecTV thing.
Wow.
Are you
That's okay.
a big
you
TV
can't
watcher?
Watch Dexter.
Not really.
You're too busy.
No,
having
actually,
fun,
Denise just made me get TV for the first time in like 2 years. So. It's really kind of weird.
I just DVR everything.
Yeah, everything
crazy.
Is DVR'd.
I Hulu.
Like, we got TV on Friday, and so I think for the last 3 days we sat in bed and watched TV.
Mm. That's what I did, but that's kind of sick.
I watched more episodes of Storage Wars than last weekend than I know what to do.
Isn't that cool, some of the shit that they find in
there? I'm actually a... participate in that kind of world, so
really, that's really interesting.
Like, my personal life,
so
is
storage,
one of my favorite
Storage
things,
Wars
so.
Is the one that's a little more scripted, I think. Than
yeah, it's
the
a,
others.
They've got the guys that, you know, there's too much bullcrap be backstory for me on that one. So right. Plus, I have issues with if you buy something, you got to sell it, right? So they assign value to stuff, and I'm like, wait. Doesn't mean, you know, just because this pen, you know, could be worth $20 doesn't mean I'm going to sell it to Mama for $20. So,
right.
So
Mama ain't buying a pen for $20.
So,
just to let
now,
you know.
Hold on. I know a little bit about going to storage units and buying them and stuff. So what do you do with all the stuff that you buy?
At one point, I had a secondhand store and sold all that kind of stuff. And then today, I have a partnership with some folks at the Charleston Antique Mall that sells us some stuff. And
that
then,
used to be the Red Rooster Antique Mall,
it
right?
It did, yeah, except they moved it up to Decatur or something, I don't know. And then I think my girlfriend wants to kill me for the rest of it. So, yeah, I went to an auction yesterday and called her on my way home and I said, sorry, I bought a table lot. So, two truckloads worth of shit.
So now, where do you put this stuff? You
take most it of home? It I actually threw out. Okay. Well, you know, we go through. You buy a table lot, 6 foot of junk. It's all kinds of stuff mixed in.
And you just have to take your time.
You weed through it and figure out what you got and figure out, you know, well, we found some antique dishes.
Is there a lot of good money? Can you make good money doing this?
You know, it's been a profitable business for me ever since I got involved. So
if my
know,
storage unit ever got sold,
they'd be in a shit ton of money.
A geek would be in fucking heaven.
There's gotta be a couple of thousand comic books.
Well, it's amazing what you keep a hold of. I mean, and you don't really think about this until you start really evaluating and the things that you keep a hold of in your life, and you go, "Wait, do I really even need this stuff?" I mean, at one point, I had this huge collection of like Star Trek action figures and stuff, and I hadn't looked at them in years. I mean, they were just in a box, and so one day I said, forget this. I'm just going to liquidate all these. Yeah. And, you know, I made like $2,000 liquidating stupid action figures that I hadn't even looked at. So, yeah. And I think
I've been thinking about doing that with my comics, too, because yeah. I haven't looked at them or anything in years. So
I could totally pay for my surgery. I might.
Great. Now she's got to hit your storage
everything
unit.
Everything is for the surgery now.
Well, when you need it. From what I understand, gallbladder pain is
terrible. It is terrible. I remember when I would have it, all I would want to do was like, I don't care if I have to buy over the counter sleep medication and OD myself, because I just wanted to sleep through the pain. It's so bad.
You know, I had two attacks before this one, and they were bad.
You
and
were
I
having
had
one
on
Sunday
air.
Night? Yeah, last Sunday night.
I had
night,
one on air a
one.
Couple of weeks ago. Was it just a week ago?
It was
ago?
Last weekend, yeah.
Seems like forever ago.
Yeah, you barely made it to the end of the show.
Yeah, and those were survivable attacks. Like, I could get through these. This one... And they only lasted a couple of hours. This one, 4 hours into the attack, I had called Cali Guy a couple hours before that and said, please come over and just be with me. And a couple of hours after he got there, I after the second time I threw up, I said, I can't do this. You need to take me to the hospital. I know I don't have insurance and it's going to cost me a ton of money, but I need to go. And he took me. And I was there another 5 hours before I finally had relief. I mean, it was a 9-hour gallbladder attack.
Not me. I was in so much pain, and they were like, oh, maybe you just have an ulcer or something. And I was like, look, let me fucking tell you, there is something going on.
Well,
and I looked at DJ, and I said, I'm going to the hospital because I don't think that this is what he's he knows what he's talking about. I'm going to get checked now. And we went there, and literally I'm on the gurney bent in half because that was the only way that I could get some sort of relief. And he came in, and he said, I'm going to give you some pain medicine. And he said, it's very, very strong. And it affects people differently as I'm bent in half, as he's putting it in. And I look over at DJ and I say, can you help me up? And he's like, no, not already. I was like, yeah, I'm good now.
Well, it helped that when I showed up at the emergency room, as soon as I mean, they had me in and filling in the, like, I'm sorry, I don't have insurance. I promise to pay the bill you send me stuff. As soon as I signed my name on that, I said, please go get me a barf cup. And he went and got me a barf cup, and I filled the fucking thing. And they... boom, had me right in the back. They were like, here's a note. No more barfing pill. We don't want to see you barfing anymore. Let's take you to the back and get you away from everyone else. And
they make a no more barfing pill?
Yeah.
Sweet.
And it worked.
That is pretty cool.
And she was like, it dissolves on
however,
your tongue.
However, you have to stop barfing to take it.
Yeah.
Though.
Yeah, and you hope you don't good. Barf it but back that, up,
hey,
right?
That's a trick. You can go, as soon as you go to the emergency room,
just throw
barf,
up. And they'll see you immediately.
With my luck, they'd want to do an anal cavity exam or something. We ran out of the barf pill. You have to take it as a suppository. And Merry Christmas.
It was this teeny tiny little dissolvable pill. I put it on. It tasted like crap. I was afraid it was going to make me throw up again because it tasted
I can remember just walking the halls at my mom's, just like walk, hoping that it would somehow relieve the pain. It's horrible. It's like a knife.
Let's get back to this. Let's get off of this. Let's go back to penis.
Right. Penis,
by the way, very much helps gallbladder.
Stop doing that. Last week, the fucking nausea thing with the pregnancy. This week, now you're saying that it helps. Okay, you are giving him too much ammunition. You know that he already fucking tells me that that's good for everything and that any irreputable doctor would tell you so, okay? Stop giving him more ammunition.
Irreputable.
Right. But what I'm telling you is Thursday night. It was Friday night. Cali Guy came over and spent the night with me, and I was like, not feeling good. And we were going upstairs. It was pretty late. I said, if we're going to have sex before I need to go to bed, we need to go upstairs now. And he was like, we're going to have sex tonight? You don't feel good. I said, honey, I smashed my thumb in a car door, and it was black and blue, and I still had sex with you.
I remember that story.
We're going to have sex.
She and had her finger in an ice bucket while she was having sex with him.
I had my thumb in an ice bucket while I was having sex with him. And we went upstairs and had sex, and I felt better the next morning.
You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNetRadio.com.
Penis
we'll
cures
be
everything.
Right back. Yay, penis.
The sound of On Wheels Now, every Tuesday at 6 p.m.
If you like cars,
the smell of gasoline and rubber,
or just love motorsports and auto racing,
On Wheels Now is your inside look at local motorsports.
So don't miss the action.
We'll keep you in the loop with the latest local racing news.
We're race car drivers, too. So join me, Michael.
And Mike, Tuesday at 6 p.m. Find us at onwheelsnow.com.
Attend the annual trade show where all your favorite adult BBW entertainers will be. BBW Fan Fest 2013, July 26th, 27th, and 28th in Las Vegas at the Tuscany. Find BBW Fan Fest on Facebook for more info.
Eve of destruction, tax deductions, inspectors, bill collectors, population out of hand, suicide, too many bills, people all over the world are shouting in.
Sir Cooper, every Thursday afternoon at 3 on VegasAllNetRadio.com and on the third Thursday of the month at 3 right here on KLAV.
Yes, this is Sir, and I approve this commercial.
Hey you, this is Vince here on the Talk with Vince show, where no subject is off the table. We'll explore the depths of your mind. Spirituality, we talk it. Enlightenment, we talk it. Politics, we talk that too. Ufology, you want it, you got it. Conspiracy facts, we're on it. Sex, we talk it. So join me every Saturday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. for Talk with Vince here on VegasAllNetRadio.com. Talk that will blow your mind.
Hey, Luis, where are we going today?
Dude, I just heard about this great place called the Greek Lounge.
The Greek Lounge? But I'm not really into lamb or slofaki.
No, man, not the Greek Lounge, the Geek Lounge.
The Geek Lounge? What's that?
Yeah, dude, it's your one-stop shop for talk about everything from movies, video games, comic books, TV shows, manga, and anime.
Wow, when does all this happen?
It's every Sunday at 4 p.m. on VegasAllNetRadio.com.
Oh, man, it's almost time. We better hurry.
You're right. Don't forget, that's the Geek Lounge, Sundays at 4 p.m. on VegasAllNetRadio.com.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNetRadio.com. It is time for the Nationwide BBW Club Calendar. Woo-woo. Get on Facebook. Go to Nationwide BBW Club Calendar for these and all of your club events across the country. Post your events on there, and we'll read them out loud on Sunday night. First of all, Simply Beautiful Classy and Sassy Lingerie Show, October the 13th in Pembroke, North Carolina. Tickets include admission to both the fashion show and the after party. $20 are the tickets. Email Andrea Wells on Facebook.
BBW and their admirers from Delaware State will be hosting dinner on October 13th at 7 p.m. Meet at Catherine Roomies, 1616 Delaware Avenue in Wilmington, Delaware. There will be a live band. For info, find Larry Geltzer, G-E-L-T-Z-E-R, on Facebook.
October 13th, BBW and BHM Club Plush Pink Party. That's all a lot of peas in there. Orlando, Florida. We encourage everyone to donate $1 for Susan G. Komen for the Cure. Most Pink. If you wear the Most Pink, you get a $35 bar tab. Woo-hoo. Go to clubplushtampa.com.
You going to put M's in Deluptuous this week, too?
Yes, I am.
LBC's Wild Halloween Bash. It's the Boo Bash, October 18th through the 21st at the Holiday Inn in Carroll Stream, Illinois. Go to chicagobbwbash.com for more info.
BBW Club Catalina Halloween BBW Bash, October 20th at 9 p.m. in San Diego. Check out Club Catalina BBW.com.
Little Darlings Las Vegas BBW Strip Contest, Thursday, October 25th. And it's a BBW costume contest. Dress up or get naked. Come down and have
fun. I'm judging that one.
Are you really?
Yay! Thursdays are always thick at the Power Exchange Las Vegas. More info, go to powerexchange.com. You know I've come in second the last two times.
At the Power Exchange?
At that one.
Oh.
Little Darling.
You know, for the right kind of bribe. Could be your year.
I'm telling you, penis solves everything. Houston, Texas.
I'm good at it, too.
Houston, Texas, BBW Halloween Bash 2012. Starting Friday, October 26th, it's a meet and greet and scavenger hunt. Saturday at the Holiday Halloween Bash, 9 to 1. Oh, it's a 1, yeah. 9 to 1. Private pool party to follow, Crown Plaza in Brook Hollow, Houston, Texas. For more info, go to Facebook and look for Houston TX BBW Halloween Bash 2012.
BBW Club Las Vegas Halloween Party, Saturday, October the 27th at 10 p.m. at the Red Label Ultra Lounge on Sahara in Las Vegas. For more info, go to bbwclublasvegas.com.
Save the date. Club Plush in Tampa's biggest party of the year, their Halloween, October 27th bash. 10 p.m. Go to clubplushtampa.com.
Club Impulse Twisted Fantasy Halloween Costume Party, Saturday, October 27th. At 9 p.m., $10 cover. Go to club-impulse.com.
It's the second annual Rock Your Curves Plus Size Fashion Show, A Day in Fashion. November 10th at the Crown Plaza Hotel, LAX Airport, California, produced by Cheru.
NAFA Capital Chapters PPP Pajama Party with a Purpose, Saturday, November the 10th at 9 p.m., Holiday Inn, Laurel West, Maryland. Go to NAFA, that's NAAFA.org.
BBW Vegas Bash Cruising, leaving from Long Beach to Mexico, 7 days on the Carnival Inspiration, January 13th. For booking info, go to the Facebook page, BBW Vegas Bash Cruising. If you want more information on these and many other wonderful, fantastic,
well, first of all, you're not done because there's one more. Excellence BBW Winter and Winter Weekend in Vegas, February 7th through the 10th at the Tuscany Hotel and Casino. Go on Facebook to Excellence BBW for info.
There, Stu, you got your plug.
Now, for this and other information, go to the Nationwide BBW Club Calendar on Facebook and post your events. Yeah.
There's also a couple other things that they're not BBW centric, but there's the Fantasy and Fetish Ball, which is coming up, I believe. That's a huge thing here in Vegas. And then you've got stripper karaoke.
We have stripper karaoke every Wednesday night at the Hustler Club.
Every Wednesday at the Hustler Club.
How fatty friendly is the Hustler Club?
Platinum's there every week.
Platinum's there every week. Like Desiree's there every week. So,
all right.
I think that's
what I'm trying to say. You better be careful. She's mean.
Desiree's mean.
Y'all better leave my girl
she's
Desiree alone.
She's especially mean to me.
Is she?
Yeah.
Now, what the fuck are you two giggling about? Okay, Silent Mike and Alexia just started busting up laughing.
And
at
they're the only ones that are in chat.
Okay, right. So one of the a couple of things that we were talking about during the break is Diamond Dave wants to know if there's a bigger punch card now for Mama.
Why does she need a bigger one?
Because penis cures everything, which is what DJ's been trying to tell you forever, that penis cures everything. Right?
So that should be a donation then.
Kathy Hernandez from Club Catalina joined us in chat. Woohoo! Hi, Kathy. And then we also have, Where'd she go? I just saw her name. Shalia 72. There she is. Shalia 72. She said big shout out to Mama.
Hey.
So Cali guy says they do make a no barfing pill. It's a suppository.
Oh God.
So see? Did they put it in your mouth?
Oh, they gave you the wrong hint.
You messed it up.
Don't let him lie to you.
No
they
wonder
gave me a teeny tiny little pill that they put on my.
And you said it tasted like shit.
It did taste like shit. I believe that there was an option for something else too to go up my butt that I opted out of. But I was pretty doped up. Like I still had a lot of pain. I just didn't really care much. Until that last shot of Dilaudid.
Give him enough morphine, I don't think he'd care whether it was your ass or your face. It doesn't matter.
Wouldn't really care at some point.
Okay, so now he just puts up, it is made in two different forms. So there you go.
But they're both anal.
Thanks, Kelly guy.
That was funny. He's just contributing to the humor of the show.
He has been having me giggle all weekend, which has been great.
Doesn't it hurt, though?
And penis. It does.
Because I made you laugh the other day via a text and you told me to stop.
Well, that was back when I was still very sore from vomiting all night long. My back and my sides. It was like I'd been slammed with a baseball bat a few hundred times.
But don't you like that?
Oh! No, I like leather and PVC striking instruments, and that's only
PVC.
Well, a lot of things PVC? Are made out of PVC.
Oh. Wait a minute, when you had that bag at the power exchange, I didn't see no PVC pipes coming out.
He didn't bring
that.
The cane with him.
Oh, we didn't get to see it all. Well, no. We need to do this again, though. Because I only got half the show.
Look, I already had a problem trying to eat some frozen yogurt the other night, and I like the fruity ones. I like pineapple. So tell me why the only option the other fucking night was mango.
Mango
tart, by the way.
No, mango is sweet.
By the way, they were selling tart mangoes for 99 cents at the dollar store the other day.
Pete, I know you're very busy, so you don't get a big chance to listen to the show, but that's what mango is, the name of her female part. Yeah.
From now on, you will never think of mango and not think of my true. Vagina.
Hers is biscuits and gravy.
That makes a lot of sense, actually.
For those of you who are just joining us, we are in studio here with Pete Housley, who is the guy behind...
The mastermind.
I like to go with God.
The God.
Oh.
The mastermind.
Oh.
The James Bond
true.
Of all industry Twitter. Tweets, period.
I don't know about that.
Now, if you're following BBW Girl Tweet, which you probably are since you're a fan of the show.
And if you're not, you're dead.
Or if you're following Porn Star Tweet, or if you're following Comedy Tweet, or if you're following
all... Can you list them all?
I can't do it off the top of my head.
I can't.
I can go read them off of the Twitter list.
Yeah, well, there's more than that.
Or gay porn Tweet, mm-hmm. or any of those tweets, then you know Pete Housley.
True.
Because Pete Housley is the guy who came up with the algorithm. Is that the right the term? The algorithm that was able to aggregate all these
Twitters? Well, you've used two really 50-cent words right there. I'm not sure I can
You know what? I would only give her 75 cents really? For those words.
For like a combo
75
deal?
Cents is more than the 50 cents he was
no,
offering
No, for both
me.
Words together.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. They're 50-cent words each. Yes, it's an aggregator. So, yeah, it's 3 years old. We've had the Naughty Tweet Network for going on 3 years, a little more than 3 years now.
Yeah, right.
There's, anytime, there's 18 of them.
Yeah, anytime he tweets once, her phone explodes.
True. Yes.
We would like you to
We know how to go to work.
So. We would like you to bow out of the special recognition category this year at
Man,
so
we
can
worried.
Get so we could get another award. Really, but we were like, oh God, Pete Housley's against us. We're fucked.
Yeah. Stubo and Pete Housley.
We're fucked.
I'm pretty sure I lost because I wasn't actually there. I sent Denise in my stead, who is my girlfriend, by the way, and I think you met her. So she got to stay here with you guys while I went to Chicago for Exotica.
But we were told we did give the best acceptance speech.
Did
we
you?
Broke the
and
stage.
We broke the stage.
Nice.
It was trying to cave from under our fatness.
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
It was great.
Okay, so I know
well, Platinum said I had to do some special favors to win, so clearly I know how you guys won.
That's right.
We did.
Goddamn straight. That's right.
It's not
and
a problem.
We're not doing that again.
You've already made that very clear for the little darlings.
You should see the holes in our punch card, goddammit.
They're porn stars.
I don't know if I'm dancing this year or not.
No?
Okay, so we're very familiar with you because we've had you on the show before, and we're
it's
huge
been a
fans.
Long time.
Yeah, it's been a year and a half, I think. Mm-hmm. But we're big fans of you, and you know, I stalk you on Facebook, I have to admit. But let's,
you are
let's
my
give
personal
a,
friend on Facebook.
I am, mm-hmm. yeah. So let's do a little recap of where it is that you started as a host at a gentleman's club, right?
When? No.
No.
Who is this? Who are you talking about?
She didn't just say that.
Wait, yeah. Fact checkers are going to work right now.
No doubt. Mitt, Mr. Romney, could you get a fact checker on that?
Uh-huh.
No. Well, I used to be a corporate kid. I was an IBMer for years.
Well, yeah, that too.
And then when I came to Las Vegas, I was a marketing director for a couple gentlemen's clubs.
Marketing director, that's what
and
it
then,
was.
And then I was the general manager of a few.
There we go.
Correct.
So you got your finger into... You put your Something. Finger into the sex industry here in yes. Vegas, and then everything...
Actually, I was in the business before coming to Vegas.
Were you?
Yeah, we, in 1980...
He put his finger in a long time ago.
True. In 1998, we had one of the cam houses in Atlanta, actually. We did Voyeur Cam, and it was called Club Voyeur, and we had 38 cameras in a house with a bunch of crazy strippers that lived there, and
But we that was real big at one time.
We were doing live streaming before people were doing live streaming.
They're still doing it, but was it because
the business is very different now.
I was going to say, yeah.
But we were doing live streaming video before people were doing live streaming video, so we kind of blended a lot.
Now, did you get into the sex industry world because you were trying to meet girls?
No. Absolutely not.
No.
I think that's one distinction between me and a lot of other guys in this business is I didn't get in it for the pussy. I got in it for the money.
For the money.
Yeah.
I thought he was going to say the bony. I was like, oh, really? That's a new one for your girlfriend, I bet.
Morning, I'm gay. No. Surprise.
And then, so you melded the two worlds together, the sex industry and your IBM
experience. Yeah, we sit the fence a lot. I mean, and it's a lot of times, and I know we've talked about this before, but it's a lot of the exposure we've gotten over the years is because we are corporate and not everything we do is like, hey, look at us, we're screamingly, you know, out there and being crazy. I just did an article for the Brazil, you're going to laugh, but it's the biggest tech magazine in Brazil, and it's called Info, and it's hugely distributed, and I was amongst three other just huge names that they interviewed, and one is Stuart Lawley from .XXX, the other is our good friend Fabian from Manwin, and Allison from Pink Visual, and the title of the article was The New Kings of Porn. So it was a great, but it's very mainstream, and so we talked a lot about how we got there, and kind of everybody's background, but it's interesting because we get to do that. We were on MSNBC, we've been on CNN, we've been in the Huffington Post.
Not Fox.
Yeah, because we're not like, we're just not like totally out there just constantly going, hey, you know, look at us, look at
penis,
us.
Penis, right? Penis, vagina,
yeah.
Vagina.
Yeah, we're not that organization. So, and I think that's helpful to the industry a little because we can kind of ease people in. You know, I think we're the lube in the industry.
I love that.
The analies of the industry.
I mean, and like when the Free Speech Coalition came to us and wanted to talk about the Measure B issues and the condom stuff, and they came to us because we have capabilities communicating with consumers and with talent and industry
Are you guys pro condom?
I was just
going to
ask that. Where are most of the girls standing on that?
Whoa! Careful, pro choice is not the right discussion.
No, as far as like how are the girls in the industry feeling about that, or like what side are they falling on, and what side are you falling on?
Well, I mean, first of all, you know, there's a lot of misinformation in the condom stuff, and the testing procedures are pretty significant, and I think the testing works that exists today. You have to have a test every 30 days at a minimum. Most producers now require every 2 weeks. There was the syphilis issue last month or in August with Mr. Marcus, but that was an isolated incident. I mean, there hasn't been an identifiable HIV case on a porn set in many, many years. And that's because of the testing and because of the realities. You've got a better chance of going out and having sex with some guy in a bar and getting, you know, HIV. So for me, it's an invasion of privacy, and any good liberal will tell you that. The government shouldn't tell me whether I should be wearing a condom or not.
Yeah, because they're adults. They're consenting adults.
True. So the biggest problem is the amount of money that is going to cost to actually enforce that law, because porn sets are not, I mean, there's not like, oh, we go to the ABC studio and shoot
studio
porn.
B.
You know, we shoot
we're
porn
at
in
John's house.
Yeah, we're in the car outside.
You know. I love that kind of porn, by the way, where they're fucking the car stick thing. That's awesome.
I mean, so it's almost unenforceable, and the amount of money that California will spend trying to enforce it is just outrageous. And, you know, just for clarification, it is the Republicans that are driving this home and making that a big, big problem for us. So, you know, hey, I don't know. Maybe I'm stupid, but that sounds like big government to me. So,
yeah,
it does.
Yeah. It kills me that it's the Republicans trying to do that.
Yeah,
they're the
that
ones coming up
wanna
like with the illegitimate babies, and I'm running off to Brazil to find my soulmate, and I'm Arnold Schwarzenegger, and I got, you know, kids with the nanny. They're all Republicans.
So, you know, the condom law is a big deal. The Measure 8's coming up. So if you're in California, please go out and vote no against Measure 8 because
it's got the horrid number 8.
Is it only for California filming
it's,
in
it's
California?
It's actually only in L.A. County and the counties.
Oh, well,
there,
all
so
people to do is just not film any longer in that county.
Well, it's one of the things that there's one of the discussions.
Well, a lot of them are moving. That's why a lot of the girls have moved to Vegas, probably.
A lot of discussion about production moving to Vegas. And the unfortunate part about production in Vegas is a lot of it's not zoned to happen here. There are some zones that you can
problems,
do some stuff.
Yeah.
So they're still trying to figure that all out. So, but
unfortunately, in reality, Pete, like, who knows that you're in a warehouse somewhere shooting a porn?
That's the problem. Is the enforcement is just going to be ridiculous.
Yeah, if you rent a building for private use, it's private use. Whoever they decide to rent it to use it for, that's their choice.
Yes, I know. It is illegal to shoot porn in Clark County without a license. And a lot of people who shoot in hotel rooms are actually have problems. And in
what
fact,
kind
there was
of license do they need?
They need a license to shoot adult content.
Now, is that only for adult content that's going to be generating monetary value, or is that all adult content, period?
It's probably monetary. I mean, for commercial purposes. Okay. So, but there was a case a couple years ago.
You can't make any money on your porn.
Well, there was a case a couple years ago when everybody used to come in for AVN. We all used to stay at the Venetian, and 6 months later, you'd see a DVD come out, and every scene shot in the Venetian.
If you're just tuning in, you're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasOnNetRadio.com. We're sitting here with Pete Housley, the god of Twitter.
I like it.
And all the aggregate Twitters that are out there, Pornstar Tweet, BBW Girl Tweet, and any of those that you follow. He's telling us about laws here in Las Vegas when it comes to shooting porn. If you are in Clark County and you are shooting porn without a license,
you know, it makes me wonder because I've shot
breaking
some
the
porn.
Law.
I've shot some porn here in town, and it's making me wonder if
you're probably,
I didn't need the
you're
license.
Probably
they
the
did.
Law.
Whoever was shooting porn.
If you want to further your career without doing any porn. whether it be acting, modeling, or athletic career, you can contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
No, I don't think they'd have a problem.
Yeah, so
that's
so
a great segue, by the way.
That's impressive.
We're
good at that.
That was impressive.
Yeah, so I'm sitting here wondering, how many times did I break the law in
this
town?
This week?
Yeah.
Well, it's stupid. I mean, there's a lot of dumb laws on the books in the country. So, I mean, it's anal sex is against the law still
in
Georgia.
Yeah,
in
a lot of places.
You know? So,
you can't put it in your pooper in Georgia. That's why they fuck each other's cousins.
I grew up in Atlanta.
Without the cousins poopers.
There was a great story. This guy was a peeping Tom and watched a husband and wife engage in anal sex. And he went, hand to God, this happened. He went to the police and reported them.
I was watching them, and they did this.
Did he get convicted of peeping?
He got convicted of voyeurism, or whatever the appropriate, and they got convicted for sodomy.
Wow.
He said,
I'm like, wait a second.
That's
what
fucking unbelievable.
He said,
idiot.
He said, hand to God, so I can see him
true.
Just holding his balls.
Hold my own head.
Hand to God.
True. Hand to Twitter God.
You know, hand to Twitter God. That is so fun. Like, that's like. Stupid. When were a lot of these laws put on the books?
Millions of years ago.
And why?
There's
like
so many dumb laws that are, like
1982.
The town I grew up in, you're not allowed to walk a cow down the street on Sunday afternoons. I mean, dumb stuff that just never come off.
In the city of Las Vegas, you can't drive your car down the street without a lantern boy in front of you.
True.
Because you might scare the horses.
True.
Really?
And it was just never taken off the books.
My lantern boy is waiting out front.
I'd like a lantern boy.
Oh,
waiting for me out front.
Okay. His name is Paolo, and he comes with a coconut and an umbrella.
I'm like, where's my lantern boy? I could use a little lantern about now.
Wow.
So now every Wednesday you are at the Hustler Club. Where is that, by the way?
I don't know.
It's off
Larry
of the
Flint.
Freeway.
It's over on Dean Martin.
Yeah, you can
it's
see
right
it
next
off
door
the
to the playground store, which is
awesome,
it is. By the way.
True.
It is right next door to the playground store.
It looks like the carnival. When you're going down the 15, you look right, and it's the big carnival.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's right there, big sign in the front. Yeah.
Okay.
I actually sent Larry Flint from Hustler an email one time, because after the first Little Darlings competition I was in, he did a whole segment in his magazine about the competition and I just made a pole disappear and my ass is in the magazine. Whoa. So I sent him a text and thanked him.
Nice.
Thanked the guy at the Hustle for putting us big girls in the magazine. So now I get all kind of emails from Hustler Larry Flint for president.
Wow, you get a lot of emails coming
in. I do.
I
vote for Larry Flint.
I know.
Would you
bone him?
I would. Can he still bone?
I'm not sure.
I think
he's
kind of
like
bone.
Grandpa on Hee Haw. He's stuffed and not alive. So,
Now, so you hang out there every Wednesday, and you hang out with all the strippers. Is there stripping going on?
Yes.
While there's
absolutely
karaoke
it's required.
Going on?
It's required. Officially called stripper karaoke for a reason.
Oh, so if we went, she would have to get up there and
absolutely.
Strip?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a requirement.
I'm glad I'm all your official naked
and
one.
And we're in our own room in the back of the club. It's actually the original club. The Hustler Club was built around another club that pre-existed there. And so they renovated the room. You'd love it. It's actually the Mail Review during the weekend. So it has really sexy pictures on the wall for you.
Oh, nice.
I find them offensive, but... Mostly because
you don't like Wang in your face.
Well, it's the guys have six packs, and you know I have an ab, so
one single ab.
It's a cool room. So we have our own bartender and our own wait staff, and we run it. My good friend George from Rebel Base Karaoke comes
we
over.
We need to go there.
Yeah,
I do have to.
In
tell
fact,
you,
he actually knows Two Tons very well.
Well, Two Tons, who was on your show last week, right?
Right.
Actually started stripper karaoke with me 6 years ago.
Really? He didn't tell us that.
He didn't mention that. Yeah.
Two Tons and I are very good friends. We've been friends for many years. So. He was the original host of
you know
stripper
what?
Karaoke.
Fat chick world is a very small world.
It is.
Oh, it's time for a mandatory break.
That's all right.
It is. It's time for a mandatory break. We've got to break the show up.
Don't jump under the desk.
I'm scared.
We've got to break our show up into
I just wanted
pieces.
To comment on the amount of food in this room. It's pretty crazy.
You're in a room full of fat chicks. What do you expect?
My girlfriend said to me, she says, I know you're going to eat dinner on your way out. So she went to eat. And I was like, well, what are you talking about? She goes, you're going to freaking Curvaceous. You're going to have tons of food. So in front of me, like coconut macaroons. There's like
pizza.
17 pizza boxes up there.
There's only two, by the way.
And we haven't offered him a single thing to eat, except I have offered you payment for...
Mama gave me some water,
sorry.
Which I think they recycled. So.
No, that's fresh, right out the box.
Right out the box.
So we got to break our show up into two pieces so that when you download it on iTunes in 4 months, when I get it up there, you'll be able to download it in two pieces equally.
And see, I didn't call you out last week. I just said webmaster.
Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNightRadio.com. We'll be right back.
Don't go away.
After we pay our bills.
Get connected to your audience with Endeavor Media Group. Find them online at emgnv.com.
Embrace your endeavors and take it to the limit with Endeavor Media Group. Visit them online at emgnv.com.
If you're looking to further your acting, modeling, or athletic career, contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
Endeavor Media Group is a sports and entertainment PR firm, connecting its clients with audiences everywhere through movies, television, radio, publications, websites, mobile applications, and special events. Visit emgnv.com.
EMG represents clients of all sizes and in a variety of industries. The firm works with companies, organizations, famous individuals, and political groups to advance their interests, manage communication-related matters, promote products and services, handle issues, and mitigate specific problems. Visit Endeavor Media Group online at emgnv.com.
Sweet Cheeks with the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City. In this election year, knowledge is power. Know the issues, know the candidates, and remember to vote. Your vote is your voice. And besides, you get a really cool sticker.
Hi, this is Luis from the Geek Lounge. You know, every year, thousands of them are being destroyed without even a second thought. What am I talking about, you ask? I'm talking about used video games. Every day, thousands of games are being neglected and traded after people have lost interest in them. So when you go to your local video game retailer, tell them that you want to buy used and give a game a good home and a good console.
This is Luis from the Geek Lounge reminding you that no matter what console you play, please buy used, not new.
This message is brought to you by the Geek Lounge and the Epic Awesomeness Council, who are also the Geek Lounge.
Welcome, mabuhay. This is Gina, your host from Gina B Live USAP USAP at Vegas All Net Radio. Las Vegas, baby! Gina B Live every Thursday, 3 to 4 p.m. Join me to talk about Filipino, Asian American culture, entertainment, sports, events, and my accents. Gina B Live USAP USAP at VANR every Thursday, 3 to 4 p.m.
Tuesday nights at 7 p.m., it's the wildest, most radical sports talk you've ever heard. It's Uncut Sports. Uncut Sports Talk, Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. Join us live every Tuesday night to talk Monday night games, college games, pro football games. Every Tuesday night at 7 p.m., you now have a choice. Listen to those other dumb shows on other stations or tune in right here on Vegas All Net Radio, Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. for the greatest Uncut Sports Talk you've ever heard. 7 p.m. Tuesday nights.
This is Jim Jonas asking you to listen to Veterans in Politics. Veterans in Politics is a weekly broadcast internet talk show hosted by myself, Jim Jonas, and Steve Sanson, president of Veterans in Politics Incorporated, that airs every Saturday from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. at www.vegasallnetradio.com. Veterans in Politics' sole purpose is to teach, educate, and inform veterans on issues and the candidates that will affect them. Too many politicians say they support veterans and their issues, but their actions tell a different story. Here at Veterans in Politics, we will expose these politicians by giving them a chance to come in and explain their actions to veterans so veterans can truly make informed decisions. Listen every Saturday to stay informed and to hold politicians accountable for their votes.
Saturday nights from 7 to 10, it's the Chill Zone with your host, Randy M. Join Randy as he takes you through a journey of smooth electronic music and beyond. It's the Chill Zone with your host, Randy M. Every Saturday night from 7 to 10, only on Vegas All Net Radio.
The honorific Smash debut album, Yay, is gonna make you wanna sing.
Just gotta sing to make the whole world ring. Just gotta sing to take your mind off the hurry.
With hits like Just Gotta Say.
Just gotta sing.
Only in my dreams.
It was only in my dreams.
Suspicion. It must have been love.
It must have been love. But it's over now. It's all that I wanted. Now I'm living without. Must have been love. But it's over.
Yay is available for a special low price at Amazon, Rhapsody, Reverb Nation, iTunes, and at theautorifix.com. Theautorifix.com. Yay!
This is Cheryl with the Diamond Star Radio Show on VegasAllNetRadio.com. Listen in on Tuesdays at 4 p.m. Learn tips on taking your business to the next level. Maybe you're at $50,000 a year and you want to increase your business to six figures. Yeah, it's possible. Join us. Also join us at our business-to-business mixers. Check out our page on VegasAllNetRadio.com for those locations and times. We'll see you there.
See the award-winning Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City and your favorite BBW porn stars at BBW Fan Fest 2013, July 26th, 27th, and 28th at the Tuscany Hotel and Casino, Las Vegas, Nevada. For more information, go to BBW Fan Fest on Facebook.
Follow your favorite BBW porn stars on Twitter. Find them all at BBWGirlTweet.com.
Speak. Her face looks scared, her voice.
sounds weak. If this shit is getting bad, I don't know what to think. I made a mistake, I was turned to the brain. Now I know exactly what she's going to do. And I know I'm gonna lose her if it's true. But damn it, I don't wanna lose it all.
views and opinions expressed on the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City do not reflect those of this radio station or its affiliates.
Calypso, Alexia, Sierra, and Sweet Cheeks are personalities put on for your entertainment.
All music, stories, and characters are the sole property of their creators and are protected under international copyright laws.
The stories are real. The language is explicit. The behavior is outrageous.
If you can't take the heat, get the fuck out of the kitchen.
Well, my girl's got the sweetest pussy, nestles in her lap. Be the first to admit and want to stroke that kitten, fell right into her trap. Now all that fur and purring gives me cause to pause. She may have a pretty kitty, but watch out for those claws.
Blasting to you straight out of Las Vegas, Nevada, it is the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City, starring Sierra, Calypso, Alexia, and Sweet Cheeks.
Welcome back, everybody.
In a wild world.
I'm like, I'm so lost.
That's in a wild
world. Yeah, it was supposed to be Mama.
It was supposed to be me.
Whatever, she pointed at me.
I know. Get your pointer finger fucking right, okay?
Whatever. Hey, the music that you heard during our break, that was our very own Vendetta with a song called Lose It All. We're missing our Vendetta. We haven't had him for a couple weeks.
I just sent him a text message. Where have you been? Haven't heard back yet from
Bitch,
my
get
boy.
On the phone.
So you're back to the second half of the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City. We're here in studio with the god of Twitter.
I like that.
Not the creator, but the god of Twitter, Pete Housley.
Like
the bald god of Twitter.
True.
For those of you who follow BBW Girl Tweet, because I know all of you do who listen to the show, that's all on him.
No,
him,
it's not.
Him and his uni-ab.
His uni-ab.
That was coined by Cali Guy, by the way.
I like the uni-ab.
It's called uni-ab.
Platinum Pussy does a lot of the work on BBW Girl
Tweet.
She actually is our ninja.
That's her title.
I don't think she can move that fast.
How do you like being called a ninja?
A ninja?
You know, one of my favorite porns was called Four Ninjas, and it was about four girls who dressed as ninjas who would break into your house very quietly and have sex with you and then leave very quietly.
Can they break
platinum.
Into my house? I'll leave the door open.
There is nothing quiet about platinum.
I was offended that you said I couldn't move that fast.
I was trying to be nice today.
No, you're not. You've already got Desiree's on.
Are you on the side of the road, or did you guys make it home with your hot car?
We made it home because God is so gracious. He looked out for us, and it just so happened that we pulled in. What had happened was we were out. We were out running errands, trying to get everything taken care of before the show, and as we were driving, the little gauge that says that your car is extremely hot was telling us that it was very, very hot. And we just happened to be around the corner from the house. We pull in, and just as we turn off the car, it's like steaming. You can hear the hissing noise. It smells like cupcakes. And the gauge is like having an orgasm, and it just so happened there was this lovely gentleman.
That's the antifreeze.
No, it kind of smells good. I don't know if it's
That's
just
probably
me.
The cupcake you were eating.
And this mechanic guy was sitting outside. He happened to be our neighbor, and he was walking by. And he comes over and says, "You guys having car problems?" And we were like, "Are you serious?"
No. We do this
for
fun.
We're baking cupcakes on the engine.
Cocksucker.
So nope. He was a kind gentleman and fixed it for us. It took about an hour or so, but, you know, he got it together and the car is back in temporary business. But he's a super, super, super sweet guy. We have to say thank you, Roger.
Yes, he wouldn't even take my money. Like, I kept trying to shove my money down his pants, and he was like, "I don't want your money."
That's because
not what she was doing in his pants.
Desiree, that's because he wanted something else.
Boobies.
But he was more than happy to take the box full of beer that we had left over in our fridge from the previous tenants.
That's because he's a mechanic.
That's what he said. He said all mechanics drink beer.
They do. And all mechanics take payment in beer, too. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah, so we're okay now. We would have been there, but, you know, apparently the silver bullet road warrior has been screaming for help. Well, you know, the thing is, before I left Phoenix, I paid to have a complete tune-up. And as he's pointed out to me, they failed to change the plugs, the wiring, or the hoses. So,
you got hosed.
So yeah, are we still talking about your car?
Yeah.
Remember, we discussed We discussed this. Desiree is mean. You can't be.
But she's not here.
Desiree, I stood up when they were trying to say you were mean. I was trying to defend you.
That's not true.
Oh, well, I appreciate it.
Let's play that back. That's not true at all.
I did say don't talk about my girl.
Can we get a replay on that?
Don't
call him Obama. He's at least challenging you.
Fact checker.
Is that Mr. Clean back there with all those jokes? I didn't even know he talked.
Mr. Clean.
I thought he just smiled with his reflection in his teeth. He's got some nerve to talk about me.
Like I said, you're not here, so I can say anything I want.
But she's like,
but you will eventually see me.
That's true. Well, the good news is I can see you coming, so I can run pretty quick still.
You'll see her shadow about a week before she will be her.
Well, plus your car's steaming, so.
You know, for a big bitch, I'm pretty stealthy.
For a big bitch, you're pretty what, Desiree?
I'm pretty stealthy. Oh. I can get around.
Right back to the ninja, right back.
Everything's connected, I'm telling you.
Well, I got to say, girls, that I went over to the girls' place this week to help them with something, and it's really cute, their new place. It's homey. So
yes,
very homey.
Isn't that code for small?
No. What
she's not a real estate agent.
No. What I meant by homey, like I was there while they were unpacking and they had their furniture starting to be put in place. It's really a nice place.
We totally dig the cupcake kitchen. That's awesome. I was wondering if the cupcake girls had done the decorating for you.
No, but the place is actually pretty big. Until we get into it, then it gets small.
No, it's really a nice place. It's beautiful.
I love cupcakes. So we did a lot of cupcake decorating and, no, it's been great. It actually really is coming together and feels homey. Like, you know, we were at Target today, and we found these amazing red velvet candles, red velvet cake candles. And so now when you walk into our house, it's like red velvet cake. Oh, my God, it's like a little orgasmic.
Awesome.
Every time I walk in, I'm hungry now. So I'm going to gain like 80 pounds with smelling fucking candles.
Because you're just going to have to keep making cupcakes.
Don't spoon the wax.
There's no calories in candles.
Anything new
though, right?
Going on with FanFest, ladies? Okay,
no.
Guess not. Next subject.
Well, we've been pretty busy working on the strip-off that takes place at Little Darlings on the 25th, and that's pretty much been the new FanFest thing, is just, you know, because BBW FanFest is the official sponsor for the BBW strip-off there, so we've been busy with that. Yeah, and now that we're, you know, semi-situated, we're going to start working on the, you know, FanFest again. Definitely. We've got some sponsors. We're working on locating our title sponsor and just, you know, some different revenue. Yeah. We're, you know, have to be a lot more creative this year with funding. So.
But we know you can do it.
Yes. Let's go back a little bit to this BBW strip-off that's coming up at Little Darlings. How many girls do you have so far that are signed up to dance in that?
Well, there's been some changes. Apparently, Las Vegas has some strange laws about what's considered amateur and what's not considered amateur. So, originally, I posted that, you know, porn stars were welcome and anybody that was in the industry could come and, you know, participate with the amateur contest. Unfortunately, that has since changed. So, anyone who's listening, we totally apologize, but the legal assholes have informed us that we're going to have a separate strip off for the porn stars, which there will be a prize, but it won't be the grand prize.
Right.
And also, because the way that the event is structured, they had to limit the amount of participants. So I think it's, not going to be more than like 15 girls or something.
Is that 15 total, Desiree, between the porn stars and the non-porn stars? Or is
no,
it,
that's just the amateur
there's going to be a total of 15 for the amateur strip-off.
Right. And then whatever porn stars, participate in whatever event, we're going to do for them. But, we're going to, they're going to hold auditions for the participants to kind of narrow down the list, because they have a list that's quite extravagant right now. And
wait a minute, time out. They're going to have a strip off when?
Well, they're going to have at some point. Platinum and Little Darlings are going to get together and do auditions to narrow down the list of participants. So,
wow, that's new.
When that's going
to
take place, we don't know. We have to. She'll have to get a hold of Little Darlings and work out the schedule. But because it's such a big, list, and we only have one night, and we're limited to time, so they don't want it to last forever and ever. So they want to narrow down the list of, participants.
Well, that's good to know that you have so many girls that are interested in stripping and in the amateur part of it.
Well, a lot of the big change, the problems that they're experiencing, the reason why it's been a long process in getting this going is that when we came on board, we changed the format and the structure of how they're doing the strip-off. Before, they just basically were like, whoever shows up, and
yeah,
we'll do the strip-off, and then that's it. Well, this year, it's a lot more structured because we're involved, and, a lot more people are getting the word that there's this strip competition, and she says usually it's the same people every year.
Right.
It hasn't been
true.
Last 2 years.
We've gone the last couple years.
Well, last year, the first year that I did it, which was 2 years ago, we had about 20 girls participate. Last year, there were only 7 of us
right
in the competition. So,
wow.
Yeah.
But we, I didn't even hear about that one until like 2 weeks
yeah,
before.
Yeah, they didn't publicize the last one very well at all. Like, it wasn't, you didn't have much advance notice to get there.
Right.
So,
and it's going to be nice to have actual girls DJing at this time.
Well, I know that I have been like telling everybody and their mama, and they all of them have a lot of questions, like, how many songs do they have to do? What do they have to do?
Yeah, what is the
what's
format?
The, how does it work? And that, I don't know, a lot of people have had questions like that. So could you tell us like that, how that's going to be kind of?
Yeah, basically what it is you'll bring the initial competition will be 2 songs. Roughly, you probably won't do the entire 2 songs. You'll do probably like 1.5. And it'll be based on the judges. They're going to be looking at the type of connection with the crowd. Yeah, and it is full nude. Everybody needs to know that it is full nude. So you got to get naked. You got to dance. You got to, they're going to be looking for things like your personality, your presentation, what your costume looks like, how far you go as far as higher presentation, and, your actual performance. So there's more than just showing up and getting naked. You're going to need to go out there and perform. Because, there is a judges panel, but the final winner will be based off of audience participation. So even though there's a panel of judges, we're just going to be there to narrow down,
the
top
four.
So.
Hey, you're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNetRadio.com. We are on the phone with Desiree Devine and Platinum Pussy. Love saying that name, who are giving us an update on the upcoming BBW Girls Strip Off being held at Little Darlings October
25th.
Which is a Thursday night. DJ says he's got a bunch of friends from his work site in California coming.
He does. He pumps.
Have a question for you. In the past, we were unable to bring our own music. And it was just, it was done in 2 sections. You went out the first time, and it was a 2-minute dance to whatever they were playing. And then the second part of it was, then you came back again and did a lap dance for 2 minutes. Now you're saying a song and a half, or is it still going to be like the same 2-minute format, and there's only one part, not a lap dance part? Do we know what's going on there?
you're allowed to bring your own music, from what I understand. I think they're actually encouraging it. And because they want your music to be more what you feel comfortable dancing to. And it's supposed to be two songs. So, but, you know, they're going to not play every song, the two songs, you know, fully. Because if you have like a 3 or 4 minute song, you'd be up there for almost 10 minutes. So they're going to try to do up to two songs for the initial competition. And then the second competition is going to be limited to a little bit, you know, less time.
So you will. So we will be on stage twice.
Yes, and the thing about it I wanted to share with everyone is that you get tipped while you perform. You keep that. Yeah. So even if you don't win the ultimate prize or any of the runner-up prizes, you still get to make money while you perform. So
I gotta strip again.
That's a lot of $1
bills. I gotta pay for my surgery somehow.
A lot of $1 bills.
Stripping for surgery.
I'm bringing a roll of quarters.
You could be a doctor. The costume.
What? We've got the costume contest as well. So there's a lot of $2,000 for the one winner takes all for the cash prize, but there's also going to be some runner up for first, second, and third runner up on the strip competition, and then there's the costume contest, which is $1,000 cash plus some runner-up prizes as well. And the porn stars, we haven't gotten a dollar amount yet, but they're going to have a prize as well.
So what is the costume contest? What do they have to do for that?
It's recommended that you wear something that's not going to get damaged, because it's going to be wall-to-wall
damaged
people there. No, so don't wear wings or, you know... Tables. Yeah, anything that you would not want to get damaged at the plate, you know. Or if you bring it, wear it on stage and then take it off.
This sounds like a very long evening.
It is.
It's going to be a long evening, yes.
Is it going to start earlier than 1 a.m. this time?
Yeah, usually
it's supposed to start at 11, and all girls need to be there at 10 that are going to participate.
That sounds good.
And what time
I'm
going to
need a nap
there?
For that.
What time does Pete have to be there?
10:30.
Needs to be there by
10.
Sweet.
Like
and,
a girl.
And just
like
for informational purposes, I can be bought as a judge.
Don't be telling everybody that, because we already have an agreement
well,
here.
Right. Well, just for clarity, Little Darlings does not serve alcohol.
Right.
And oh, yeah.
That's a huge, huge problem for me. So.
No, it's not. I'll tell you how to overcome that one.
Why
do you think I'm nudge? I don't take cash. But vodka?
Okay. Well, don't worry.
Oh!
I'll have a titty flask.
Titty flask.
You can drink out of my titty flask.
Yeah, you've been trying to trick me with that for years.
This is true. I finally find my perfect opportunity.
So now if Sweet Cheeks enters the contest, is she an amateur? Can she only do the costume? Or does she have to be one of the porn stars?
I think that depends on how many views she has on X-Hamster, huh?
I haven't done... My last porn was 3 years ago.
Yeah, I don't think that she...
I've been in the competition the last 2 years under an amateur. I didn't even know that they said
so
she couldn't be.
Does that work like virginity? You're born again amateur?
No.
No. 90 days. It's 90 days. You're back to being an amateur.
Back to being a virgin. I like it.
I think I should
have you ever made it 90 days?
What?
Have you ever gone 90 days without sex?
Yes.
When you were pregnant? When?
Wait a minute. I have not had
she
sex
real
since
sick.
The bash.
Yeah.
Really?
It's been 90 days for her, at least.
Holy God.
But I'm going to take
care
of that.
My whore is
week.
Lacking.
Oh, my God. No. It's either sex or Obama.
True.
Okay? Like my time.
Sorry,
I don't
I'm
have time for both.
I'm not that political.
I haven't had sex since last night, and I'm already having withdrawals. I don't know how you go.
Oh, please.
90 days.
Yeah, it's not
She's
easy.
She's probably the master debater we all know. She could whip Romney's
well,
ass.
Well, is there anything else we need to ask the girls while we have on the phone? It's about time for a break, so.
No.
Anything else you guys want to mention?
Nope, I think that pretty much covers everything. And BBW Girl Tweet is also a sponsor for our lovely BBW Strip Off as well.
And if there's anybody else that's interested in being or auditioning for the contest on the 25th, how do they contact you?
They can contact me via email at platinumpuzzy@gmail.com. And the audition, I think, is just really to see who shows up, because a lot of people sign up and don't show up. So
right.
If you're going to be in the audition, or if you're going to come to the show, show up for the audition and, you know,
so when, all you got. What is the specifics for the audition again?
I will get back to you as soon as I get an actual day. They haven't narrowed it down yet, so as soon as I know, you will.
Okay. All right. We'll put that out there, too, so everybody knows when they have to go to be in the audition.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, I hope the car thing works out for you ladies.
Me, too.
It will. We, you know, this guy that was helping me tonight was amazing, and we're going to try to help him open up his own little mechanic business.
Very so cool.
I really dig people that, like, you know, he just helped out of, you know, the kindness of his own heart and refused to take my money, you know, and is going to help fix my car for, you know, pretty much the cost of parts. And
but did you offer him? But did you offer him the titty flask?
I did not.
Maybe she'll let him drink his beer from between her tits.
Hey, Desiree, maybe we can get him to power up the Lushmobile.
Maybe he has a friend who's a surgeon.
Or maybe you know what? We can just do that on Desiree and Platinum's dining room table. Okay,
I would pay for it in beer and have it done out of the back alley somewhere.
Hey, there's always Dr. J.
What if we have surgery?
Oh yeah, she knows the parts. That's true.
What are we having surgery on? I missed it.
Oh, she needs to have gallbladder surgery, but no insurance, so
nobody will pay.
So do I.
So yeah. We're gonna do it next week here on the show. So.
Oh, great idea! We're gonna do it live in the studio.
On camera.
Oh, Dr. P.
Yep.
I can tell you, Sierra, if you get some maybe a little bit of lift in your shoes and gain about 100 and something pounds, you can pretend to be me and go to Phoenix and get your surgery.
That'd be awesome.
There you go.
Right.
I'd have to dye my hair and color my eyes, but my eyes are already colored red.
Thank you so much,
you know,
ladies.
What's up? thank you
for.
I was just gonna say we could get buy one get one free surgery. You get one and all.
Well, yeah, but they only have to get it at the same time. If they only have to use one surgery room at
that
the
would
time,
be all,
yeah,
I'm
that
sure
would be all right.
Yeah, go into the, you know, doctor's office and say, "Do you have BOGO?"
Yeah,
BOGO. Mexico does really cheap surgeries. I'm just saying.
Lord.
You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Cincy on Vegas All Net Radio. Thank you to Platinum and Desiree. We're coming back with Pete Housley and Ketchups. Don't go away.
All right.
Hi, this is Joseph Peroni, author of the book From Grief to Relief. Listen to my show every Thursday at 2 p.m. on VegasAllNetRadio.com. This show is dedicated to those who have loved and lost and have found or are searching for the personal power and courage to love again. Join me, Joseph Peroni, every Thursday at 2 p.m. on VegasAllNetRadio.com. Heard online all over the world. Listen to the From Grief to Relief radio show every Thursday at 2 p.m.
Join us at the annual trade show where all your favorite adult BBW performers will be. BBW Fan Fest 2013, coming July 26th, 27th, and 28th here in fabulous Las Vegas. Find BBW Fan Fest on Facebook for more info.
This is Sierra from the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City urging you to adopt, not shop. There are hundreds of thousands of animals out there looking for homes, and you could be their next forever home. Visit your local animal shelter today to find your next family member.
Treat yourself to some afternoon delight on VegasAllNetRadio.com with Nights Over Las Vegas and The Commander, playing music everybody knows and loves. Nights Over Las Vegas, replaying every weekday at noon on VegasAllNetRadio.com or download an archive to listen at your pleasure.
Find all of your favorite adult BBW babes on BBWGirlTweet.com.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNetRadio.com, where you can say whatever the fuck you want, and we do.
And the people well, around
now,
the world.
Now, Platinum's kind of pumped me up a little because I was seriously considering not doing the contest this year.
$2,000 is a lot of money.
It's a lot of money.
I would.
Runner-up?
That she didn't say.
A basket full of toys, remember? Yeah. I got 2 fucking baskets full of sex toys.
Well, you know, if you win the basket full of toys, we got giveaways for the next 10 parties we go to.
That's what I made the gift baskets out for FanFest from all my strip winnings. Nice. Yeah, exactly. So I don't know. I will see. I'm twice as old as most of those girls in there, so we'll see.
All right, so we have to give away this. We have an hour left in the show. We've got to give away the glass dildo
butt plug.
Glow in the dark glass.
I think that we should take stories from our online listeners as to what they would do with the damn butt plug.
I think that's a great idea. I love that. So post your,
you know what? Because it's coming from BBW Girl Tweet in 140 characters or less.
Wow.
Let us know what you would do with the frosted glass glow in the dark butt plug.
It needs to be a little more specific than I'm going to stick it in my ass.
Right. Yes. But. And the one we like the best, we vote on, it will be sent to you.
You the most
we can all, and we can all put our lipstick to lips on it if you want us to.
And we're going to take possession of this from Pete because he's a very busy guy, always back and forth from here to California and other places in the country and
Chicago
and at the stripper club on Wednesdays.
He's always busy.
That's where I live actually.
So next week, all your submissions come in this week on Twitter. And I'll tweet it out later, and then we'll pick one. And next Sunday we'll announce who the winner is, and then we'll send it out.
Just sounds for fairness, right. This is from our very good friends at Crystal Delight Toys.
Crystal Delight
so
Toys.
So in your tweet, it would be nice if you included their Twitter, which is Crystal D Toys.
Yes,
Crystal D Toys. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. Right. What are you going to do with that thing?
Awesome.
I think we ought to put the Sin City Bounty logo right on the end.
We'll get a sticker
on this end.
Yeah.
No, I want after it's inserted for you to take a picture and be able to see the three ladies logo.
That's what I want.
No,
I want
put
my
it on
logo
right here on the outside.
SinCityBounty.com.
Yeah, that's what I want. I want my logo in someone's ass.
That's what we're doing. We have the new porn star tweet toy coming out, and it have a tweety right here. And we have a new glass strap on that will come out with tweeties all up and down.
Nice.
Like ridged in
you
tweeties?
Have a tweety on your penis?
No, I have a tweety on my arm.
You do have a tweety on your arm.
I do have a tweety on my arm. There are 15 porn stars with tweeties, tweety tattoos.
Really? That's very cool.
Including Platinum, who was just on the phone.
Justin, we're not listed on BBW Girl Tweet because we are not porn stars.
Well, half of us aren't porn stars.
True. Half of us are
I'm
not.
I'm only amateur.
No, wait
I don't know
a
if we get that X-Hamster number up. You could be listed.
It's
you
guys, 12,000. DJ, what is that number now?
14,247 is what
he
told me last.
That's huge.
And that's for the second video, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
The first one, when he told me earlier, is at 612.
Hmm. Hold on. I'm loading it. Current number is 14,264.
Oh, and that's even more than when he texted me a little while ago.
That's 10 more than at the beginning of the hour.
247.
10 more. But 7 of those are you.
No, only 3 of them.
Okay, hey, y'all, embrace your endeavors and take it to the limit. Contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
That was a horrible segue.
Yeah, I know it, but I haven't done it. We haven't done it.
I find here's the tip on how to do segues. First, you announce who we are.
True.
Since we have to do that anyway.
Do we?
Hey, you're listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on Vegas on the radio.
That way we don't go straight from butt plugs to EMG Entertainment. Right.
And then you go, and we're here with Pete Housley.
Who?
The god of Twitter.
True.
With his uniab.
I am reminded by text that you guys are listed on Industry Tweet.
Yes, I was going to say that. I got interrupted, which happens often on this show.
True.
Before I finished the thought. We're not.
Where's Jim Lair?
So we were talking about my red eye.
So we're not listed on BBW Girl Tweet, but we are on Industry Tweet.
Right, but you do have a banner on BBWGirlTweet.com.
Yes, we do. And I want to get some of the stars from Tranny Tweet in here.
Absolutely.
Oh, I would love that.
I know you would.
We love trannies.
We love trannies.
We have a new we're about to announce a new ninja.
Mama's our booking agent.
We're
going to
have a new ninja for Training Star Tweet. Brittany has retired from the business, who's been helping us with training for years. And so we have a new ninja going to be announced the next week or so.
Awesome.
Very excited about
training
it.
Training ninja.
Awesome. Training ninja.
Well, I want to tell a little bit about my catch up, just a little bit.
Yes.
All right.
I'm going to get me some butter this week.
Woo, bazillion butter?
Bazillion butter.
Nice. Okay. I was going to say, what kind of butter?
No, not nut and butter.
Because you don't actually get any butter with nut and butter.
No, you don't get nothing.
And, but you do.
And, no, you do. And not only to mention, but every girl that knows him
tells the same story?
Yes.
They all call him nut and butter now?
The same fucking they don't
know his name, but they all have the same experience.
The same story.
So we'll go over that real quick. Nut and Butter is the guy who picks you up at a bar, takes you out to your car, bends you over the hood, rubs your ass, and masturbates, and that's all you're going to get out of him.
Well, he didn't
is
pick
he
me
white
up.
Or black?
He's black.
Or Hispanic?
He's
okay.
Black. He's very black. Tall.
I actually know a white guy that does that.
And no, I have to say he didn't pick me up at a bar. We talked at a bar, and then we had kept in contact, and then he picked me up, and we drove out to the very dark lake, and I thought I was going to be...
Same story.
Sliced and diced.
Yeah. He has a spot. At Lake Mead.
Same story with mine.
Yeah.
Well, so I can call mine bread and butter. Right?
This one went up to the mountain and was overlooking the change of plans. But yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's not some Brazilian butter. So Brazilian butter and I have, he started working midnights and we have a hard time connecting. So we talked this week and we said, okay, on this date, like we had to make advance notice to try to fit each other into our schedules.
Sex does need to be scheduled.
Sometimes when you're, you know, when you're fighting Obama, sometimes,
Don't touch my butt plug.
Oh, so I think that's, I don't have much more of a catch up.
And random clips. What time is it? Let's write down the time on that because I need to pull that out and we just need to play that clip randomly.
What's that?
Don't touch my butt plug.
I'm going to Twitter, so keep talking.
No, so it should be fun because I haven't had sex in a while.
Brazilian
butter. It's been too long.
Yeah, why?
But you've been concentrating on Obama.
She's been making an excuse for not having sex with people because the only people currently involved in wanting to have sex with her also want to have a relationship with her.
Oh. So that's the dealio.
I don't have sex with people who want... I don't have sex more than once with people that want to have a relationship with me.
I want to have a really in-depth discussion about when do you get out of a relationship? Not this show. But when...
No, I have the answer for that. We don't need to talk about it. You never get into it in the first place.
Well, we know your answer.
It's like the number one cause of divorce is marriage.
True. Pete, I have serious commitment issues. Nice. I've been divorced twice.
That's all right.
And so I just sport fuck. And if they want to, if it's more than that, you got to go. Delete.
When they text you 2 months later.
No clingers for you, huh?
No. She is not Star Trek.
You know what? But we have talked about the fact. We have talked about, like, if I found the right person, I would make the time. And, you know.
It's such an excuse.
Such a lie.
Well, let's say this.
There's fact checkers' heads exploding right now.
Here's the thing. I think I would make the time and make the effort. Okay? I would like to think like I'm not a hopeless case. Like maybe there's part of me that would, you know, call
Stop
somebody.
Stop making my gallbladder.
But I'm telling you guys, I'll tell you this. If I ever change my Facebook status to in a relationship.
Oh my God, I would keel over and die.
You should.
The devil will call us and go, damn it.
Because the idea of changing that means something way too serious for me.
Yeah.
Way too serious to change my Facebook
status.
You know,
that shit really kills me. Facebook.
Yeah, 5 years ago.
I really wish that it was that easy. Just like, you piss me off, delete. You know, I mean, like.
No, you could do that because you and DJ would be deleting each other all every day.
No, she'd delete DJ. He'd be the guy who deletes you and then comes back. And I don't know what I did, but I deleted it, and now I'm back again. And
if we have sex, it'll make it all better.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, he did say he would, you know, we were talking about my Facebook for Sin City. And I get a lot of, I want to buy you something. You're beautiful. I take you shopping, you know, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So he said that if I wanted him to, that he would write me references.
So that's what they make Amazon wish lists for.
You know what? Yeah.
We're working on ours.
last time Pete was on the show, he suggested that we get an Amazon
wish list. We're working
on
them. We're working on
I have mine. I don't know about you ladies, but I've got like 30 objects on mine.
We have an entire website about it.
There you go.
So about wish lists for porn stars.
I've got to put a gallbladder surgery on my wish list.
You might as well. I mean, some of these girls have cars and stuff like that, and people are
Do
actually
they get them.
Yeah, they get all Jesus kinds of crazy Christ. Stuff. So.
Yeah, I noticed some of my people on Facebook that have that or that have said something. It's like, oh, I got some nice shoes. Look at my shoes that I got in the mail today.
I'm like, you know, as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing wrong with getting
a
present.
No, I don't agree.
You can do it completely anonymous,
right?
Too.
And what's great is that I can get a present and I don't have to make a commitment.
True.
It's her favorite thing ever.
Presents without commitment.
Really,
yes.
See, I think you guys.
Did you want to lay down and have this conversation?
I feel the need to have a defend myself.
No,
right.
There is no need to defend yourself.
But I really do want to like get old, grow old with somebody someday.
Well, you got Facebook. That's good.
Who invited this guy?
I did. I did, damn it.
True.
You know what?
I'm coming back every week now. I knew it was going to be this.
You got a hot man.
You said, you know, she says she wants somebody to grow old with, but
true.
That's already happened.
They fuck with me because I am the oldest one in the room.
That's rough.
That's not why we fuck with you. We fuck with you because you make it easy.
Right. No. We fuck with you because you're old.
No, I don't believe that. I don't think so.
We fuck with her because as soon as we're polite to her, we hate her.
What's wrong with you? Why are you not talking to me?
I'm such a nice person.
No, but that's so true, though. Anywhere you go, as soon as somebody becomes overly polite to you, then you know they don't like you.
True.
Yes, in DJ's family, they if they speak to you and say, hello, how are you doing today?
Really?
Oh, you
they
know
don't
you
like you.
Oh no, my favorite. I grew up in the South, and so it's hilarious. You know when Southern ladies don't like you because they'll look at you and they'll be, "Oh, how are you?"
No, aren't you darling?
Aren't
That's
you
a good one. Aren't
special.
You darling?
Darling.
Oh, honey, please don't put your no. Please don't put yourself, out for me. It's okay. all right.
I used to have this cousin, and my dad's from Kentucky, and she was a little bit slow, I don't or whatever. But she'd always like slap you on on your leg and go, "Oh God, love it,
God love it,
God love it."
True.
So, all right, who's got a catch up? We know about your gallbladder catch up. You got another
my
one?
Eyeball. Sex.
Sex.
We had sex
lots
calls.
Of sex.
Well, no, we didn't have lots of sex. We had sex the one night, and then we were very tired, and so we didn't have sex last night. But we will be having sex again. Oh, so I stopped taking my hormone pills, and I'm supposed to be starting like a period. I stopped taking my hormone pills.
Are they like birth control where you're supposed to stop
one week?
Yeah,
you're supposed to stop and flush your system because we're trying for me to not be in menopause at 32. We're trying to reboot my system.
Okay.
So I stopped them 4 days ago, and I still have not had a period. So I'm a little worried because if I don't have a period in 7 days, am I going back on the hormone pills or do I stay off them? I got to call my doctor
well,
now and find out what
if
this
if it's
is
like
about.
A birth control pill, you go back on them after 7 days.
I know, but I don't know what I don't know. My body's so fucked up right now. I just need a new one. I'm putting that on my wish list. New body.
Nice.
I just want new knees and ankles.
That'll work.
I'd be good with that.
Yeah.
Wow. So the USB hub that looks like a guy on my wish list is just like
there's nothing.
Nothing compared to
$8
you guys
USB
wishes.
Guy, yeah.
I want knees
I've got
and
a $4,000.
She wants a gallbladder out.
There's an R2-D2 USB hub that I have. Ooh, that I really
nice,
want too.
Nice. There's a great Doctor Who one out too.
You know what?
I put a set of pots and pans on mine. Literally. I put a new set of pots and pans.
You should. That's
I
the
put
kind
the
of
entire
put.
Series of Stargate on mine.
You should.
I have pots and pans on mine and patio furniture.
I have tablets and e-readers and accessories.
You should see some of the stuff that
I have earrings. I have earrings on mine.
Put clothes, lingerie.
Yeah.
Jewelry.
Yeah.
Mine's good.
So, Mama, give us your catch-up.
Well, after last week with I said we don't have sex now without a light in my face, I have been given a 2-week no light in my face break.
A reprieve.
Oh, isn't that special? I bet you he's got an infrared camera now.
No,
that's
telescope. Oh, damn. I am blonde. I don't know. I should have thought about that. It's probably hiding somewhere. And
he's got that shit.
So light in our room lately. No.
That shit, he's still taping, girl. Don't even kid yourself.
Well, watch him pop up on there.
No, he said it. And when he does say stuff, he's like, he keeps his word. So I'm not too worried about that. But he keeps saying, damn, I got an idea. Fuck, I told you 2 weeks. Damn, I got an idea.
Say,
fuck,
write it down. Write it down.
So I'm going to be busy next week.
He's going to keep a porn journal.
Right.
You know that, right?
Okay. It's kind of a little porn black ideas. Book. It's a porn journal.
Or like anytime we do something, now, damn, this would be so hot on the camera. I'm like, shut the fuck up. You gave me 2 weeks, so leave me alone. But
wait, what did you have to trade for the 2 week reprieve?
I didn't trade nothing. Because I had made the comment to say now that
But it was true. Every time you guys were having sex, yes, you turned the light on.
Yes, all of a sudden it's like, what is that? Like, I wasn't nowhere last night, okay?
Suddenly Ron Jeremy came
you were being interrogated.
I was blowing him.
Well, I'm still like, you know, still keep me on the sister wife list.
Okay.
But she has to get the dick. I was discussing this the other day with somebody that you had to have the dick to be a sister wife.
Oh, yeah. I ain't going to be the sister wife and clean the house and take care of the kids and cook the dinner if I ain't at least getting some dick. Hell fucking no.
And how many days a week do you need that for?
Once. Just once?
No,
once
twice.
Twice?
So you need a punch card like me then.
Yeah, I'll just fill in for you.
No,
yeah,
he is not going to go for that. If I ever said yes, there's hell no. We'd all have a fucking punch card. If there, how many ever there was of us? Yeah. No, you have two.
Now, is this a true sister wife situation, or are we going to go into the polyamory thing where you and I get to fool around?
And have a boyfriend.
I have to get back to you.
You know what? We'll get a polyamory couple or family.
Family?
It's a polyamory
group.
Hexahedron or something.
We'll get them on the show before you guys make the decision of what kind. Are you in a regular relationship?
Wait a second. Wouldn't that put you into a relationship? I'm just asking.
Yeah.
But no.
I have nothing to worry about.
Wait a minute. All the pressure would be on me.
Oh, true.
See, I wouldn't have to like give it all myself because I just say go find her for the love. I'm just about, you know, the sister,
the cooking, the cleaning.
I really, especially as I watch like that show, sister,
you'll be the vessel and make us meatballs.
Absolutely. I really am about the sisterhood. Like, I like that whole idea, you know, with the sharing of the raising of the children and the camaraderie with the women. It's just like he's just a fixture.
True.
He's a dick.
Stunt dick.
Yeah, he's a stunt dick. Yeah, good life. Got
it. Guys are props. I get it.
Now, are you in a normal relationship? Or do you have one of these newfangled?
Well, she's listening.
They're not newfangled.
She is listening and watching this.
I know she is. She's retweeting as well. Yes. Thank you so much, Denise. But I mean, are you polyamorous? Are you in an open relationship?
We have a very healthy, normal,
not swingers,
monogamous
vanilla
relationship. Very relationship. Monogamous relationship. Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Are you swingers?
Nope.
No. He said monogamous.
Although many people ask.
I would say, do you want to be?
No. There are a lot of people who tell you that they are emotionally monogamous.
Mm-hmm. Emotionally monogamous. That's a whole different story than physically.
But rather than try to explain it, they just tell people that they're monogamous. I've met a few swingers that are like that. I'm like, oh yeah, we're monogamous.
Yeah, I know a lot of people that are in that space too. But Denise and I are approached every time we're out, going, "So, are you guys swingers? Are you guys swingers?
Is it because they want to fuck her or you?
Who knows? She claims it's me. I claim it's her. So. Oh.
She's very pretty.
Yeah,
she's very pretty.
Yeah. Don't tell her that. She's listening.
Denise, you are so pretty.
And now your card's not getting punched. Just so you know,
that's all right.
Unless it's Desiree punching it.
Desiree'd like to punch it.
And that'd be like a punch.
That's going to hurt.
That's going to leave a mark.
That's true.
Too funny.
That's awesome. So I don't have a lot of... I was two people this week.
Yeah.
I was John Lindquist, who does
the voice of,
the voice of KLAV and KRLV. Where the hell is... Oh, there it is. You're listening to The Gracious Bounty of Sin City. On Vegas All Net Radio, by the way, in case you didn't know.
That was another horrible segue.
I know. So, yeah. We're here with Pete Housley, and we're talking about whatever now. We covered all his God of Twitter thing that he's got going on. BBW Girl Tweet. Go follow all the girls on BBW Girl Tweet. If you are a big fan of Platinum, which I know a lot of you are that are our listeners, or Desiree Devine, they're listed on BBW Girl Tweet, and then you can meet some other fabulous porn stars on there as
there's
well.
There's a lot of girls stars? On that now.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a lot.
And it gets there's bigger pictures every day. All the time. Mm-hmm. I'm always seeing cleavage pictures and nipple pictures. And
take a look at naughtytweet.com. It's all the pictures. That's all it is. And it's in each category, so you can go and just see the BBWs, or you can just see the gays or the trannies or whatever. So it's cool.
And
cool.
Yeah, there is a Twitter aggregate from Pete Housley out there for whatever it is that you're into.
Well, not that feet guy.
I'm telling you, maybe you should have one. Check out his
don't
website.
You have a, don't
well,
you
we have,
a
have kink. We have, oh, a, yeah, you do we have kink tweet. Which kink tweet.
You know what? A lot of foot fetishes will tell you that they're not kinky.
True.
They're
you need to be feet tweet.
They really
feet
get
tweet.
Very,
tweet.
Yeah.
Feet tweet.
That's been proposed.
Denise, get that down now.
Yeah, yeah. I want a you know, a royalty on feet tweet.
There's a, you know, yeah, there's a lot of different sex and everybody's a little cautious. You know, it's the same old conversation about to,
do you have any do you personally have any proclivities to any kind of fetish or anything?
He's not telling.
I'm not telling you nothing, jeez. You're trying to touch my butt plug. Aren't you precious?
Precious.
Oh, anyway, dear. So my catch up. So I haven't been able to do much of anything this week. It's been
because you're doing double duty.
John's 8 hours is 10 to 12 hours for me, you know, doing his job. So and then on top of it, I do the website. So I have to catch up with that. And yesterday, all day yesterday, I did not go to karaoke with you ladies because I worked all night.
Well, we
didn't
go either. So just so you know.
Oh, there you go. But my thing this week is and a lot of this I got here from work and just out in regular is. My term of the week is emotional blackmail. Do you guys know what that is?
Yeah, my I got.
I use it all the time.
I got a grandmother that used to do. Thank God she's dead.
Tattoos?
But
yeah, those are tattoos. And it's just so amazing to me that so many people use emotional blackmail and they don't even know that they're doing.
If you loved me,
right? One was, and this was a job thing. I'm trying to get this taken care of. I'm going to get fired if I don't. Nice. Make sure this is taken care of. And I'm like, well, I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah, I guess you should have taken care of it, right?
Yeah. So, and I've just, it's just been, oh, that's awesome.
It's a naughty tweet.
So that's been all week long.
Those
that's I've just
rottens.
run into
how,
things
how
like that.
Is
so,
that?
And then I heard somebody was telling me about how, you know, this is their heritage and their upbringing. And I'm not going to say what particular heritage or upbringing ethnic-wise it was. And that's why they're so much better, you know. And I'm like,
really?
Isn't extolling the virtues of one race or heritage insulting the virtues of all other?
Exactly.
I think the term you're looking for is racist.
Yes.
Thank you.
And I said something at the point, and they're like, "Oh, that's not what I meant." I'm like, "But that's kind of what you did, because I'm Asian, and there was no Asian in that in that old paragraph sentence thing that you just said."
Wow.
So it's just a lot of things I've been noticing this week, I guess. And then
yeah, ignoring my text messages.
No. We figured it out. Siri is jealous of my friends and does not send me the text messages I'm supposed to have.
I sent Alexia like 5 text messages in 3 days.
She texted
and
me.
I heard
and
nothing.
Goes.
I'm like, I text you. I'm like, is Alexia mad at me? What did I do? Like, she's. I text her about going to dinner. I text her about this, you know, something to do with the show and about. I ain't hear nothing. Then
and
I'm
I
at.
Said, I don't know. Let me
well,
text
then
her.
Wait a
Hold
minute.
On.
Then I wait. Wait. Then I at the. Then I get a text from her. Sierra says you're mad at me. No, I'm not mad at you. I'm just wondering why you aren't answering me.
No, I said she's a little miffed that she hasn't heard from you. You should text her.
And then so I'm at the nail salon with Mama yesterday, and I get a text from Alexia. Did you just send me 5 texts in a row? Because I just got 5 texts. Well, no, that's what I've been sending you all week. You just got it one time.
It's Siri. It's Siri. The new updated Siri. She
is
awesome.
Well, guess what? Your guys' $300 or $400 phone and my $60
phone. I'm sorry. That's a $600 to $700.
Well, that's fine. Then you should get your text messages on time for $600.
I did it the right way and I paid less than $100.
Yeah, because with the contract. Yeah.
I renewed my contract and turned in my old one and got a rebate.
Yeah, but the value of the phone. Because I did the same thing.
Time out. Then why the hell is it your $700 phone getting your messages?
Siri, how awesome are you?
That's because you're with Cricket.
So what? So what? I get all my messages.
Is that who you have?
Yeah.
Oh. One of the girls I used to work with, I could see her text me. I say, send me that. And 3 o'clock in the morning, I would get the fucking test.
Yeah,
I've
Cricket,
never had
Cricket
a problem.
Cricket has a delayed test
really?
Problem.
Yes.
That's the only time it's ever happened was that time with her. So whatever. She's busy. It's okay.
That's what he said.
DJ, broke the DJ joke, wants okay? to know if you would be willing to mention the no strings attached video that he jokingly, of course, mentioned doing.
No.
No. She said no.
Not only no.
I'm pointing at the chat.
No. It was that big, long orange fingernail going, yeah. No.
It's awesome, by the way. Just saying.
So that's pretty much my chat. I did get a couple of tweets from, or not tweets, text messages from Tim. What's his website? Tim's 12 and 12?
No, it's timfennell.com.
Mm-hmm. Timfennell.com. Tim Fennell, as most of you know, he's
Slim Tim
on the show. He used to weigh major amounts of weight, and then he went on a running kick. And now he runs half marathons. And his goal for 2012 is to run 12 marathons in 2012. He's nearing the end of his goal, but he is running out of money. So if you have a couple extra dollars, go visit timfennell.com. That's FENNELL.com. And click the donate button, and so he can do his next couple of marathons. I think he's only got like 2 or 3 left.
Yeah, he's an inspiration when you talk to him.
I think three.
Yeah, when you talk to him, it's an inspiration. He's lost.
He did
what
it. He did it completely through diet and exercise. He did not take any pills. He didn't go on any.
I think he should contact his nutritional.
The lady that was on the phone.
How do I say it? No?
On the show.
What he ate. What
his nutritionist?
Ate, his no.
The he has tried to contact them. Yes.
No, he ate a specific. I was trying not to say it on the. Yeah. He ate a specific
meal.
Meal. Yes.
Yes. You know, like one of those prepared meals you get in the freezer.
Yes, he did. Yes.
And he did it straight through diet and exercise. He didn't have any surgery. He didn't. You know, he just worked his fucking ass off.
And for those of you who don't know. To enter into a marathon, you have to pay a fee.
Yeah.
Yes. You have to pay a fee, and if it's not here in Vegas, then there's traveling expenses and stuff like that. So.
Yeah, this is the most sadistic thing on the planet. Now, I'm into some kinky shit, but they make you pay to run 26 miles.
Yeah, go figure. Hell fucking no.
Although he's only doing 13.
Half or 13, right?
Yeah, he's only doing 13.
13.1.
I wouldn't pay to walk 12 fucking feet, okay?
I would
hell
pay.
No.
I wouldn't pay to watch the whole marathon. Just so you know, when that was on the Olympics, I watched something else.
No, all you have to do is watch the last 5 minutes and see who crosses the finish line.
That's it.
But I'll pay for the Suzy Q to add another inch to my thighs.
Amen, sister friend. You see, we got the nut of butter going on here. We got the chocolate maroon, cocoa maroons over there.
There's pizza up there.
These are freaking great, too.
By the way, I can't eat any of it. I had a fiber bar. That's what I was able
to eat. What's
going to
happen when you get all skinny on us?
Well, that's the thing is I can't lose too many calories. I can't lose too much weight either.
Well, you got to take all the fat out of your diet almost, but you can't got to stay with the same calorie count.
Because if I lose weight too quickly, it'll cause a gallbladder attack.
Now, wait a minute. So what can you eat that will keep your calorie count up?
I have no idea. I haven't quite figured it out. I've only been doing this for 4 days. So right now it's been a lot of, I'm going to throw it out there, been a lot of Progresso soup. A lot of Campbell's soup, the low-fat, high, whatever, crazy soup they got going on there. Half a cup of... This is what my typical
So you're
meal
not coming to Miles for meatballs no more, huh?
No, I'll probably have to bring my own food.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I can't go out to eat because I can't be guaranteed to know that they used fat-free cheese.
Well, they won't.
They I can't won't. Ask them to blot the extra grease off, please. You know, no
well,
more
you can
seafood.
Eat a salad. Seafood. You can eat a salad or some seafood. Seafood. You can still eat crabs.
Right, but I have to make sure that they take out all the things I can't
And no
have
butter.
In it. No butter.
Butter's
oh, you
fat.
Can't dip those crabs in that butter. Ooh, no. Baby. I had crabs Friday night, anymore. Let me tell you.
Oh, I wanted to go.
I'm going to have to find a different crab dipping sauce. I'm going to have to make like a pesto or something to dip them in.
Oh, but you know what? Those crabs are so good that I don't even dip everyone. I don't even dip everyone.
You know,
I eat them just plain.
The last time we went, when I cut my fucking finger on the crab leg, I didn't dip it all the time.
Hey, you're listening to Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasOnNetRadio.com. We've got Mama's ketchup left to do.
No, she didn't. I did mine.
All of it?
Okay. Yeah, okay. She's got 2 weeks of no camera sex.
Oh, okay. We got Pete Housley's ketchup.
Whoa.
And mustard, too.
We'll be back.
Get connected to your audience with Endeavor Media Group. Find them online at emgnv.com.
Embrace your endeavors and take it to the limit with Endeavor Media Group. Visit them online at emgnv.com.
If you're looking to further your acting, modeling, or athletic career, contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
Endeavor Media Group is a sports and entertainment PR firm, connecting its clients with audiences everywhere through movies, television, radio, publications, websites, mobile applications, and special events. Visit emgnv.com.
EMG represents clients of all sizes and in a variety of industries. The firm works with companies, organizations, famous individuals, and political groups to advance their interests, manage communication-related matters, promote products and services, handle issues, and mitigate specific problems. Visit Endeavor Media Group online at emgnv.com.
This is the Kevin Jackson Show. Join me every Wednesday from 3 to 4 p.m. for 1 hour of music, politics, entertainment, mayhem, and debauchery. It's the Kevin Jackson Show every Wednesday from 3 to 4 p.m. on Vegas All Net Radio. Join us. It's the American way. This is the American
way. Join us at the annual trade show where all your favorite adult BBW performers will be. BBW Fan Fest 2013, coming July 26th, 27th, and 28th here in fabulous Las Vegas. Find BBW Fan Fest on Facebook for more info.
Back to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City on VegasAllNetRadio.com. It's your Fat Shanista Report.
It's been a while.
I know. We always forget me.
Put my microphone on my
gallbladder. We don't forget you.
We don't?
We know. We just run out of time.
That's true. But we're going to talk about some very, very important fall trends straight from New York Fashion Week, Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week, which Project Runway always is at. Right?
Right.
All right, here you guys. Are you guys ready to know what's in for the fall trends?
In.
Blue and black together. Lots of blue and black.
So it's like the comeback of 80s hairband rock?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't think
about
that.
There's a lot of blue and black combos.
A lot of blue and black. Burgundies, you guys. Burgundies and wines are big colors. Those are your colors, Alexia. Yeah, you look great on those colors. Reptile print. Not animal print, reptile print. Snakes, lizards, alligator.
So would it be in vogue for me to take Caligae's really long snake and just wrap it all around?
Oh, yeah, you'd be right in it. We'll make you a skirt out of it, okay?
That would be some hot pictures, though.
It would.
Leather, pull out your leather. Leather's good.
I like leather.
Winter white.
Wait, what kind of leather? I like the suede, all-natural leather.
No, the leather. Not like suede.
Biker leather.
Leather. Biker like leather is in. Browns and blacks leather. Yes.
Well,
yes.
I only like that kind of leather with in the toys themselves.
And what's really hot is to wear leather with, like, while you're dressed up in something, like a dressy outfit, and throw on a leather jacket. That's, like, really cool.
I want a leather vest.
I, you know, for some reason, I just have this image of topless, no-shirt guys with nothing but leather vests and lots of hair sticking out.
Okay. Where can I find them?
At a gay bar?
You know? Really?
Yeah, no doubt.
Do you know?
I'm at a bear YMCA.
No, at the bear bar that I know where you can go, you can find a lot of them that way. But they're all gay.
Now, here's one that I'm not particularly fond of is winter white. Mm-hmm. You know, wearing all white in the winter, the slightly off-white because it's winter white. That's a personal preference, but it's in.
I think it depends on the outfit, I think.
I think it depends on your suddenness of flow. Just saying, if you don't know when you're going to go.
That's true. You have to
if
watch
when you
wear white.
You don't know when the flood is going to break loose. And in my case, I have no clue. I don't at this point know when either end is just going to explode anymore.
You got all kind of issues.
I am fucked up.
Okay, another look that's in is military look.
Ooh, I can do
you
that.
You know, lots that's of buttons and tie, the military look. And here's one we should all love, jumpsuits.
What?
Ooh.
Jumpsuits are
you have to get naked to shit.
Jumpsuits are back in. And for fat girls, not so easy when you're drinking, okay?
No, right. Because you have to get naked to shit.
You do.
Can you make me a jumpsuit with a flap in the back?
Sure.
Those are called pajamas.
We can put some buttons on those. They're actually called union suits. Union suits is what they call them. So those are your fall fashion trends. All right, okay. I do want to bring something up that's happening on Saturday.
Talk to your mic, please.
The 13th. It's Elite Curves International, and it will be the first time during LA Fashion Week in Los Angeles at the Convention Center that they will be catering to plus-size designers and showcasing plus-size designers and individuals, anybody who does size 12 and above. So this is new. They've never done it at Fashion Week in LA. So it's October the 13th. If you want information, go to EliteCurvesInternational.com.
Elite or elite?
Elite.
Elite.
CurvesInternational.com.
Nice.
All right, and I'm going to give you a couple of websites, guys. Skinny jeans for fat girls.
Oh, Lord.
I hate skinny jeans.
Well, go to
plus skinny jeans on any girl.
PlusSizeFix.com. You'll be able to find skinny jeans for
I like
fat
plus
girls.
Size websites, though.
They do. Now, this other one is a really cute website. It's called Alight.com, A-L-I-G-H-T. And what I like about this site is that you can search for your items, like that you can search by event. You can search by what's in your size, by a color, by a category. So it's all broken down. Like if you know you're going to a white party, go to the white.
For a BBW.
Yeah, an LBB for a BBW.
You know, a lot of clothing sites are going to that.
Yes, this is a really good. Yeah, it's very cool and very easy to find exactly what you're looking for and exactly your size. Mm-hmm. You know what I hate to do sometimes because I tend to have to buy on the larger end of a BBW site is to go and I have to this sweater's really cute and you click
on
it
goes to
2X. Yeah. So this way I can throw in there anything 3, 4, 5X and be able to see what they have actually in my size. So
eBay's good for that too. I love doing that on eBay. Just putting in my shoe size and seeing what I get.
Yeah.
Freaking awesome.
I know. So that is your Fashionista report. Stay in fashion. So
hey, embrace your endeavor and take it to the limit. Contact Endeavor Media Group at emgnv.com.
So what was your last blowjob like, Pete?
What? I don't give blowjobs. I don't give blowjobs.
But I'm sure you get
them. You don't give them?
That's fine. I do.
You do get them?
Sure.
Of course you do. So what was it like?
It was good.
One of my favorite.
It was in Denise's mom's basement.
Ooh, I like that. Makes it even more
that's
exciting.
That's a little kinky.
Yeah, at my age, it's kind of crazy.
He did turn all red.
He blushed. Yes.
Turn the light off.
She's probably gonna stab me. And I go home and get killed. I'll never get another. That would be my last one ever, right there.
Denise's parents aren't listening.
Yeah. Right.
Of course, she's probably going to be telling everybody
at
the next event you guys go to.
Were you guys staying there, or were you like there? Oh, did I off?
Yeah, you turned.
I want to know if you were like staying there, or if you were there for Sunday dinner, and you're like, let's
Denise
go to the basement.
Denise was gone for 6 weeks. Her friend got married in Omak, Washington, which is nowhere, and so I flew up to this wedding, and I met Denise's family, all her friends, everybody and their brother. So yeah.
So you were staying at the parents. So.
Staying in mom's basement.
Giving blowjobs. Yeah. Or
getting
blowjobs.
Yeah, careful.
That's awesome.
You have to be, have to be really quiet in mom and dad's basement. Were you like
I won't do anything in my parents' house at all.
I live with my mom. I have no choice.
Oh, I've been to my parents' house with my two husbands. And so sometimes you just got to do what you got to do.
I did it at my grandma's house.
But you
got to
eat the fucking pillow.
I just, at my age, I didn't think, hey, I'd be hitting it again in the in mom's basement.
Well, and then of course, if you're like Alexia, you're not saying things like, you know, lick my fat pussy, so you don't have
damn
to worry
straight
about being too loud.
But oh yeah, that's right. Otherwise, that's what sex with her and dirty talk sounds like.
Wow.
She can't talk
dirty.
We keep trying to encourage her.
I can.
In her head.
That's right. In my head. I talk dirty all the time. I just won't vocalize it.
She can't. It is a physical impossibility. It took 8 weeks for her to say, fuck my fat pussy.
Wow.
Yeah. That's good for me.
Do it. Say it right now.
No.
No butt plug for you.
She hasn't been practicing.
I don't know why. I could write it real good.
I was with this guy that couldn't shut the fuck up in real life, okay? Like, constantly talking. And when we get in fucking bed, he would say nothing.
Would he even moan or grunt?
No, not even. And I'm like... Like, you fucking never shut up. Can you say something sexy once in a while here?
You know, sometimes just the dirty talk gives me an orgasm.
Oh, me too. I love
sometimes
it.
Sometimes it's, I'm going to fill your fat pussy with my cock. I'm like, oh, God, yes, thank you. We're done. You can stop now. We're done.
And I'm the same way. The talk is fabulous.
Then why don't you talk?
Nasty. No. It's fabulous for me.
Oh, yeah. He's nasty. Haven't we heard stories about some of the shit that comes out of his mouth? He's a nasty motherfucker.
And he does that just for me.
Why is it so funny to you?
She can't even talk about it without giggling.
She's like, I don't know.
Oh my God. I'm constantly thinking
of new
good lines.
You know what I think it was? Is she spent so much of her life as a bottom with a ball gag in her mouth that now to actually speak or say something is probably a little out there.
No, that's not true. I was only into the BDSM thing for, let's see, I dated Chris for 3 years, maybe? Maybe four?
Maybe they were from your developmental years.
Of course, it's the way you're raised. I mean, when you're a kid, you just... You know,
please, I went to Catholic school for 12 years. I wasn't allowed to talk.
Yeah,
now it's all like, all I want to say is fuck my fat Catholic pussy.
The diocese has blessed it. Oh! Well, we went from a kosher cooter to a Catholic cooter.
Wait, who has the kosher cooter?
Calypso.
Calypso.
Oh.
She drew Jews to it like flies to a flame. It was fantastic.
It was hilarious. If we went into a big, giant party, the only Jews in the place would come and
it's
hit
her
on
nose.
Her.
It looks Jewish.
Is that what it is?
I think she looks very Jewish.
It's
I know
Italian,
she's Italian.
Though.
I know she's Italian. But she does look Jewish.
We miss our Calypso.
Yeah.
She does look Jewish.
DJ says that he's quiet in bed.
Liar.
But tell us, what are some of the things DJ says?
I want to ask DJ what his favorite line is that Mama says.
Ooh. No, I don't. Because
I'm done.
No, because anytime that I do or like into the moment or something, he's like, yeah, you said that. Yeah, you said that.
Oh, yeah. He holds
and
it against you for months
on
end.
Yes, he does. You remember when you said that? It was like, shh. Okay, I'm not saying shit else. That's what
you are listening to the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City at Vegas All Net Radio. And if you are looking to further your acting, modeling, or athletic career, contact Endeavor Media Group.
For that
yeah,
matter.
Sex career at emgnv.com.
Voiceover career. Oh, yeah. Yeah, fuck me.
Hey,
I like that.
Before the show started tonight, we had a post on our Facebook wall. So I want to give a shout out to David Smalls.
Dave Smalls.
Who said, this is absolutely the best radio show out there. If you're looking for an entertaining Sunday night, I'm officially a regular.
Yay!
Awesome, Dave. Thank you so much. And we actually had a lot of kudos this week. So
we did.
Another shout out to our freaky who posted a great picture on our wall of a big truck, a Mack truck, pulling some kind of thing. And it looks like a fleshlight.
It looks exactly like a fleshlight.
And her caption on it was, hey, my fleshlight finally arrived.
And she put, reminds me of my favorite radio show.
That's awesome. And then, of course, to Wendy of Neverland, our resident queen of Lesbos, posted a sign in a hospital that was an arrow pointing to the gynecology department and the restaurant. So it said gynecology restaurant.
Nice.
Fabulous. And then another one. If you want to know what's in your foam bras,
it'll kill you.
Polyurethane.
Is this a foam bra?
Recyclable. But yeah. The thing that got me, the thing that got me about the story that she posted was that the reason that these are so popular, not only because they hold up the boobs, but because they hide the nipples. Now, I wear cotton bras like this a lot. And so my nipples are always poking out.
Well,
so I
have
always
big nipples anyway.
I always have to make sure that my nipples are matched. Or else I got one point over here and one point over there.
She gets out the fucking level.
I remember when I went on my senior trip, we were going on a cruise, okay? And all the little skinny girls, and they put their little tank tops in, they put Band-Aids over their nipples, okay? Mm-hmm. So I remember one girl running. And now, of course.
I got ace bandages.
Yeah. One girl said, you got any Band-Aids? What the fuck am I going to do with a Band-Aid, you know?
Fucking
she
Band-Aid.
Needs an eye patch.
I need them great big fucking pads, man.
Those non-stick gauze pads.
Please, I wouldn't even try. I just go, you know. Just
it's my nipple.
Hang. Just let them hang.
Wait, I could just see Alexia and Mike at the house, her holding the a level.
The level. Yeah, and he's like, no, a little to the right.
Make sure your nipples are even.
Actually, he does help me check, because I'll sit there and I'll put my hand in my bra and I'll just adjust my boob just a little bit so the nipples are even.
Well, you need a foam bra.
And he doesn't mind checking. I don't mind my nipples showing, though.
Of course.
Who would?
Sometimes it takes a few minutes to get a response, though. Are my nipples even?
My mom.
Well, let me check. Let me see.
Yes.
My mom was a young mom. She had me when she was very young. So when I was just coming into my formative years, she was a party fucking animal. And she was and it was during the disco era. So she would put on her bell bottoms and her long Cher hair.
Fun.
And she would go out. And she had a bra that had nubs on it to make it look like her nipples were hard all the time.
Oh, that's funny.
So they would poke through
that's
her sweater
great.
Or her shirt. And
what a slut.
So I grew up with showing your nipples. So that's
you know what?
Me.
If you asked her, she'd tell you all about her boyfriend's penis.
I know everything there is to know about the boyfriend who's younger than me, by
the way.
Well,
and how does she say penis? Come on, do it in that little
she
way.
She doesn't say penis.
What does she say?
Dick.
Oh.
He got big dick, Emma. I'm like, Mom, don't tell me that. Is it like a horse? Like a horse. Mom, don't tell me that.
It's freaking hilarious. I want to be like, does he lick pussy?
I don't want to know.
Yes, you do.
It's your mom. Yeah.
You want to make sure your mother's being satisfied.
No,
well, I'm
no.
sure she's fine.
No, you know what? I'm in the same boat you are. I don't care.
I don't want to know.
I just want you to know. Miss Sierra over there. I have done her and her mother's nails
at the same time, and my mom is as bad as I say she is,
and she will start talking about things that they plan on doing and or done, and it is so funny to see Sierra go from like two.
Yeah, I go from happy and joyful to please stop making me want to vomit.
Yes, and she's like, just shut up, Mom. Just please, just shut up.
She'll just go on just as loud as she possibly can about her boyfriend's cock and how great it is.
No, I think the last
having
time.
Having sex in the hot tub.
That's what it was.
A soak and poke. Ha, ha, ha. Barf
roll. Wait, a soak and poke.
Oh, yeah.
I love that.
We were talking about last time, we were talking about the hot tub, and she was talking about remember the old place that was down on Sahara and like it's Boulder Highway or whatever it was right there. What was it called? Oh God,
like a bathhouse basically
that you rent the room for the hour.
No, it was hot tubs that you rented by the hour.
Well, yeah, they used to have one.
I can't think of what it's called
in
now.
Michigan, called,
but apparently my dad used to frequent them.
Yes. There was one in Michigan called Bubbly Tub and Tan. And you could rent, it was really cool, you could rent the room for an hour, and you went in there, and there was a little bed, and there was a big hot tub, and they had, the hot tubs was all, like, had all this foliage around it, and there was a sunroof, or like a moon roof, I should say, over the hot tub, and there's a little bed. It was really very cool.
We had one here called Spring Fever.
Bubbly. That's it.
That's the one she was talking about.
Is that still open? I might
need
to use that.
It's a bar now. It's on the corner of Sahara and Boulder
Highway.
Let's open a Bubbly Tub and Tan.
I would fucking do that.
Sin City Bubbly Tub.
No.
You can be guaranteed that if I run that place, there's enough chlorine in those pots.
And cameras. If I'm running a place, there's cameras.
you're going to jail.
They're for safety reasons.
Security. That's goddamn right. We're making sure you're staying safe.
I don't know. I used to go. When I lived in Michigan, I frequent that place quite often.
Whore.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah,
that's
big
gross.
A big room flush.
The brothel, Sherry's Ranch, has a hot tub room.
Yeah.
And
these were very nice.
It literally
clean.
Has to be drained every time a guest is in the
canister.
This was
very clean. I mean,
I don't know how often they drain the Red Rooster hot tub, but I've seen some shit in there.
I will not go in that hot tub. No.
I'll do it. I've done it.
No.
Been there, done that.
That's a sperm dip.
Now there's some
I want to be in a, and I'm okay with that.
There's some hotels that are down across the street.
I would be okay if I knew where all the sperm was coming from, but
there's
you know
enough
what?
Chlorine in there that those little
sperms hell
are
no,
in.
There's not. You see little globs float. Hell no.
I think Mama just about Ralphed on the fucking camera.
No.
That's awesome.
No. Don't go in that hot tub.
I'm with
no.
you.
You don't know what's in there. It's floating. Don't do it.
Especially if you're fertile.
You know what? The
I'm
next
telling
time you guys come over, I'm going to throw some
no,
like,
hell no.
sperm in the
That'll
hot
be the
tub.
Next thing on the fucking tabloid. I got pregnant from the hot tub.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Wait, happened. They did that in Glee.
Yeah.
They did that in Glee.
Supposedly. It didn't actually happen. Oh, but yeah.
No. But that's what she claimed. That she
well, yeah, yeah. I was talking about the hotels, too, that are down across the street from, like, the Stratosphere, too. Mm-hmm. And I've heard people say that, like, be careful because you
Those
might be
the
you might be
the hour. Yeah.
You might be the movie next week. So true. Be careful.
I actually was in one of those hotels once. Oh,
damn, you were the movie
the
of the week.
Isn't it interesting?
Fun City. Did you go to Fun City?
I don't
nice.
Remember the name. It's a while ago. Yeah, I was dating a married man.
Rooster baby. I'm a fan. Like
we
him.
Have not been to the Red Rooster and seen Geriatric
long
Heaven
time.
In a long time.
Last time I went there once. Once.
With
once.
Us, right?
You haven't been there
no,
with us.
No, I've never been there. I've never been there with y'all.
With
no.
We
no.
all need to go.
I went
Where?
There once.
The Rooster.
Red Rooster?
Mama has
yeah.
never been with us.
You've never been with us?
I've never been with y'all.
Oh, now I can schedule my period so we can go when I'm not on it.
That's right.
Yeah, I've only been there once. And yeah, it was interesting to watch the little girl emptying the ashtrays with a name tag on.
And that's it?
Yeah.
Name tag stuck right through her boobie, empty an ashtray.
Wait, was it?
No, All I heard was the clinking of the ashtrays, and I look around, and all I see is nakedness and name tag.
Swinging name
from
tag.
Her nipple piercing.
Ooh.
Oh, that's actually kind of hot.
Yeah, it is.
I'm just telling you, that's my, yeah.
Hey, we've had a great show. Thank you to Pete Housley,
Pete,
the god
so
of Twitter.
Much.
You're
thank
welcome
you.
Anytime.
You
are
you
welcome.
Guys.
Yeah, you are welcome back anytime. Anytime you got something going on, you're always a lot of fun.
As long as Denise doesn't
bring
strangle
Denise.
You.
True, bring Denise
she probably
next time.
Won't stab me.
As long as you will.
If you really want to see me get embarrassed, I'll bring Denise.
Oh, yeah. Bring Denise.
Just
we'll
a mention
talk
of
later
her
about, you know,
how
your
we work out that judging.
No worries, no worries. Our thanks, of course, to Platinum and Desiree for calling in, giving us their catch-ups. So sorry about the car, but it's fixed now, and they found a new
mechanic who takes
mechanic.
Beer. And maybe a business endeavor.
Don't forget, we have a contest for this fabulous butt plug. We have our first entry. It says, creative story. Add it as a monocle to a steampunk snowman. Realistic, put it in a butt.
True.
So don't forget to Twitter in your creative use for this fabulous glow-in-the-dark glass butt plug from Crystal D Toys. Add at Crystal D Toys to your tweet, and next Sunday we're going to give it to the most creative Twitter.
And next Sunday is our political show. We will have some Republicans in the studio.
Oh,
you know what? I am going
Thanks
to
for not
ask
inviting
them.
Me that week.
Yeah, I really want to ask them what they think we should do about the healthcare thing.
I think that's funny. We're giving a butt plug on the political
no,
week.
That's a good one.
Here are the Republicans and the butt plug. There's nothing different between the two. And speaking of, so we did a fashion report this week. We have Rosie Mercado coming on the
yes,
show in a couple
we
weeks.
Do.
We also have some sports betting guys coming on the show.
Woo-hoo. We got a lot of good things coming
we
up.
We do.
For sure.
We do.
Absolutely.
And for those of you who want to be guests on the show, contact us, info@cincitybounty.com. Mama, Cincinnati Mama down here at the end, she also takes bribes. Because
true. How do you think I got on the
yeah,
show?
Yeah, we're booked out. We're booked out about a month in advance, and maybe even more, depending on the show. So if you want to get on any sooner than that, Mama's got a wish list on Amazon as well.
Hi.
She'll go post it on her page.
I have to hold the camera
Facebook.
This week at her house. He said he wouldn't hold it.
Oh, this is good.
As Bros always, we have a great time here on the show, the Curvaceous Bounty of Sin City. Find us online at sincitybounty.com. We're on Facebook. We're on Twitter. We're on Tumblr. We're on Pinterest under Alexia. It's just a great time. I love doing the show with you ladies. I love all our listeners. All of you guys in chat, thank you so much. We'll be back next week. This is Alexia.
Mama.
Sweet Cheeks.
And Sierra wishing you all a good night. And remember,
fuck often.